Welcome to the 104th Grey Cup. Burris now, quick hitter into traffic, and it's a touchdown!
20-point lead, Ottawa.
The slogan for so many years in the CFL, no lead is safe.
Touchdown! Onside kick, and it is recovered. It's recovered by the Stampeders! 40 seconds remain. Andrew Buckley is back in the ballgame.
Ball's got to be in my hands or misses. That's how I feel.
He wants to throw now. He looks and looks and looks, and he's tripped up. What a play!
At that moment, I thought the game was over.
60 minutes doesn't solve it. Big over the middle, open man. Curtis Jackson, touchdown!
Bo Levi Mitchell needs a first down, or it's over.
Mitchell over the middle, knocked down. REDBLACKS win for the first time. The REDBLACKS are Grey Cup champions.
If this game is anything like that one, we're in for a wild, spectacular evening. You'll see these foam hats on a lot of folks, a gift to the first 10,000, welcoming them to Brick Field here at Commonwealth for the 106th Grey Cup game. This is the magical part of the pregame show where two panels become one. It's almost at least one giant panel on two different sets because both teams are on the field now for the pregame. We're going to give you our Brick Field access. Let the boys run through all the major players who could impact the outcome of this game. And since it's Jock's last game with us, you get the first draft choice.
Oh, that's so kind of you to let me kick things off. And I got to go with the Canadian. It's the Canadian Football League. And this year's top Canadian, Brad Sinopoli. By now, most of you know his story. Native of Peterborough, Ontario, played quarterback for the Ottawa GGs, drafted by the Stamp, played back up there. And then they converted him to a wide receiver in 2013. And he's done nothing but transform himself into the most dominant Canadian receiver in the league. Two-time outstanding Canadian, 116 catches this year. That's tops for Canadians all time.
Chuck, that's a good first-round draft choice, but you got to have a quarterback to throw the rock to guys like that. Bo Levi Mitchell, for those folks who don't know, he's from Katy, Texas. 7-year veteran, played at Eastern Washington. He's the first quarterback in CFL history to throw for over 5,000 yards and not have a 1,000-yard receiver. He used 16 different receivers this season to make that happen. He garnished his second MOP award the other night, second the last 3 years. Bo Levi Mitchell is a true gunslinger. It's a pleasure watching him play the game.
Well, let's talk about a guy that's going to try to shut down Bo Levi Mitchell. That's Jonathan Rose. Including the postseason, he leads all DBs with 6 interceptions. He's only one of 2 players left from the 2016 Grey Cup winning defense, Ottawa REDBLACKS. But the story all week long has been about how was he able to play in this game after pushing a ref last week in the Eastern Conference Finals. Well, he is playing in this game, and he needs to ball out. He's a great defender along with Rico Murray on that wide side of the field, and he needs to have a great game if they want to have a chance of winning.
Guys, the most dominant player on this field is no other than Micah Johnson, 14 quarterback sacks. Hey, number 2 in the league as a nose tackle, and he gets double teamed always. This guy could dominate this entire game tonight and help lead the Stampeders to victory.
Antoine Pruneau. He might be the best all-around Canadian DB in the league. He's the leader of this secondary. He played for the defensive coordinator Noel Thorpe at the University of Montreal. In Antoine, they trust. He's the leader back there.
I'll tell you, I'm intrigued by the story of this man, Eric Rogers. He played in the Grey Cup, won it with Calgary in 2014, went to the NFL for a couple of years. Serious knee injuries that has hampered him this season as well, but even on a bad knee, last week at the Western Final against Winnipeg, he caught 3 touchdown passes, a key part of the Stampeders offense with Eric Rogers. Yes, they say he is good to go. Even playing back-to-back weeks is awfully tough for him.
Had a chance to talk to this man yesterday, Jagarrett Davis, 28-year-old out of SMU. Huge part of that Stampeders defense that's finished ranked first in most defensive categories. Bounced around the NFL for a couple years and then found his home on the defensive line in Calgary. 7 sacks, 2 forced fumbles, 2 interceptions. The man is a beast.
Trevor Harris, I guess his new nickname is now T-Sniper. Absolutely love that. He was born in Waldo, Ohio. He played in Edinburgh, and he's been gracing our league for quite some time. Had a game of the ages last week. Set records. You saw the stats there. 6 TDs, 90.6 completion percentage. Trevor Harris coming into his own here.
The Don. The guy. Don Jackson in his first year out in Nevada. Only 13 games, 924 yards, 83 yards last week in the Western Finals. And Bo Levi Mitchell says there's no one on this team with more energy than him, and it's infectious. He's not only quick, but he's fast. Get him in open field, and it's going to be difficult to stop old Don.
Well, veteran left tackle Sir Vincent Rogers will be protecting Trevor Harris all night. He's going to give Trevor Harris access to those receivers downfield and allow William Powell to run wild tonight.
I had a bunch of stats all teed up, but I'm going to crumple those out and chuck them in the garbage. Alex Singleton just walked by the set less than 5 minutes ago. He looked over. I said, "What do you got, Alex?" He said, "I guarantee you today we win the Grey Cup." In the middle, he's confident.
How about the guy in the middle of the Ottawa Redblacks defense? This is Avery Williams, age 24, from the Temple Owls. Hank, you got to like
that. You know
it. Took over from Kyrie Zabair in the middle this season and has done a very solid job for a largely new Redblacks defense compared to 2017.
And here comes Weepo, William Powell, the most dominant tailback in the CFL. He had 1,362 yards this year. That was second in the CFL. He would have won the rushing title if they hadn't sat him down for the last two games. They re-signed him. They made sure he got the bonus money that he lost. Because they'd sat him down, he didn't get the title. He'll be looking to go after that stingy Stamps defense.
Got Rob Maver, 9-year vet from London, Ontario. Kid was amazing. Played his ball at Guelph University. And he is the most accurate, consistent, deadly punter, in my opinion, in the Canadian Football League has been. Shout out to his wife, Libby.
Well, let's talk about this Lewis Ward kid. From Ottawa Red Black favorite security guard, the CFL rookie and special team player of the year. What a story. This time last year, he was working security at the Grey Cup. Now he's on the verge of winning a Grey Cup. And to top it off, 51 consecutive field goals, setting a professional football record.
Well, Trevor Harris is T sniper. Well, Calgary has their own special forces led by Emmanuel Davis. Emmanuel Davis is a guy who's known to, you know, read routes, jump routes, make plays. He's a big time playmaker.
So Rod Baltimore, that's the boundary corner. He is the lockdown guy in this group. He can play man-to-man against anybody on that Stamps receiving core. Leave him alone. He's all good.
How about Derek Dennis? There he is. CFL top O-lineman in 16. Played in the Grey Cup. Had a rough year at Saskatchewan last year. He signed there as a big free agent in 2017. They moved him inside from tackle to guard, but he goes back to Calgary. He was right back home in that offensive line and at the top of his game, an all-star again. And, of course, he had to dye his hair from red to green and then back to red again.
Guys, let me talk about this man, Chris Matthews, and his story is remarkable. He was Rookie of the Year for the Bombers in 2012. He gets hurt the next year. He gets cut. He talked about Lewis Ward as a security guard. He was working as a security guard when the Seattle Seahawks called him up on the practice roster, gets on the roster, gets in the Super Bowl, has 100 yards and a touchdown in the Super Bowl, and then he's cut, and he's out of football again. Stamps pick him up in October and looking for some more championship magic.
In the first round, first draft overall in the 2015 CFL draft, Alex Mateus comes into the fold. Played college ball at University of Connecticut. He became the main center of the season, playing 17 games, Eastern Division All-Star. He'll have his hands full with that Calgary defensive line.
Well, let's talk about Brandon Smith, the elder statesman of the Calgary Stampeders, who will actually be the second oldest guy on the field. In 10 years in the CFL, all with Calgary Stampeders, this is his sixth Grey Cup. You're talking about a Swiss Army knife. He does it all. Cornerback, halfback, safety, Sam linebacker, and they'll need him to come up big today.
Well, that secondary for Calgary's will have their hands full with this next guy, Greg Ellickson. All he does is put up 1,000-yard seasons, and in big games, you better get used to 82. You're going to be hearing his name a lot tonight.
Terry Williams, he's not the feature back on this Stamps team, but he is the fastest back. He got that strike the band ability. Touch the rock and take it to the house anytime it's in his hands.
Where's the intern? Milt Stegall wants a coffee, but he can't get him one because he's going to be busy playing football. Deontay Spencer, great sport with us, and first Grey Cup experience, one of three Ottawa 1,000-yard receivers this year. Just great last week, too, with a couple of touchdowns for the Red Blacks in their Eastern Final victory over the Hamilton Tiger Cats.
Kyrese Hebert, the man they call the Angry Bird, the ageless wonder, 38 years old. Undoubtedly the most punishing tackler in the CFL. Love the way this guy plays the game. Lives on the edge, plays on the edge, He's with his ninth professional football team. You got to believe he'd love to go out a champion.
Jawan Bruskson, third-year emerging star from Mississauga, Ontario, played in Northern Illinois. Gave us a peek this year at what lies ahead. It was the only Calgary receiver to play in all 18 regular season games. Pulled a bit of a groin last week in practice, but he still put up three touchdowns this season. Had a great year.
Rico Murray, 4 out of 6 years he's played in the CFL. He's been in a Grey Cup. 5 interceptions this year, along with his running mate on the cornerback, Jonathan Rose. They combined for 10 interceptions. They'll need to maybe get one or two of those if they want to slow down both. Levi Mitchell.
Hey guys, the Stampeders running game struggled until the Reverend Randy Richards came back.
Give it to
me. Must hold his chain.
Yes. One
more time.
Give it to me.
Give Don Jackson holes. And hey, we saw him crying as he walked off the field last year in Ottawa. You know he's back for revenge.
Uh-oh, Kevin Brown, outside linebacker. Kevin Brown, he's got DB speed. You know what that is? That's a problem. Watch him fly sideline to sideline. Great speed, Kevin Brown.
As an older CFL fan, I remember Larry Hybaugh, Hall of Famer here in Edmonton with the Eskimos. That's his grandson, Trey Roberson. First year in the CFL, used to be a quarterback, turned to a corner. And he has been great in the boundary for the Stamps. And it's just sad that his grandpa, Larry, who passed away about a year and a half ago, couldn't watch him play in this field. A special day for him, James.
You know, you guys went deep in both lineups, and that's the great thing about the Grey Cup. There's always somebody. Matt Black with the pick last year. Cassius Vaughn with the big fumble return. Don't forget the rec laws are coming up in just a few minutes. Long live the night. Long live this night. The 106th Grey Cup is just ahead on TSN.
Commentator Outdoor Clothing is brought to you by Novus. This is Novus.
Where does this moment rank for you after everything you've gone through?
Oh man, this is the highest it could ever be right now. Just unbelievable. Oh, I just love this team.
I've seen grown men cry. I've seen superhero-sized behemoths fall to their knees and raise their hands in joy. All because they get to hold this century-old piece of sheet metal and aluminum. It's touching in an ironic sort of way. Many of them didn't know how badly they wanted this trophy in a city many of them thought they'd never, ever visit. But it takes a certain kind of conviction to journey to this cold place at the end of November. And when you really think about it, behind all those smiles and those tears are the decisions and the heartaches no one will ever know. All of those things now etched forever in one name. And all together, they're legacies that will never die.
Oh, this is so awesome. Man, just our team, man. Guys just believed in each other and we're able to do it tonight.
That's why I've seen grown men cry. Because they're not just lifting a trophy. And they're not just lifting a championship. They're lifting themselves. They're lifting each other.
It's a lot of tears, and then Jock's gonna cry because it's his last show, and then Davis will cry because Jock's crying, then I'll cry, and then Rod will cry, and Maddie. Hank won't cry because he only smiles. Milt won't cry because he has no feelings. Coaches will tell you that experience is everything when it comes to a Grey Cup game, and that's the same for us. Chris Cuthbert and Glenn Suter are working their 11th in the booth together for TSN. Let's hear from them as we approach the kickoff.
And James, we don't cry until after the game, yes. But we expect it could get emotional because the two quarterbacks have talked about this being a legacy game. It's that important in their entire career.
You know, let's start with Trevor Harris. You go back a week, there were a lot of people wondering if Trevor Harris could win the big game. Trevor Harris not only did that, but he did it in style with a CFL record 6 touchdown performance, and not only that, but completed 90.6% of his passes. He missed on just 3 of 32 attempts in the Eastern Finals. So he silenced the critics in that game. Now he takes the next step, and in a lot of ways, he's in the same position as Bo Levi Mitchell was back in 2014. Bo Levi Mitchell in 2012 got a chance to be at the Grey Cup as a backup, much like Trevor Harris a couple of years ago when he backed up Henry Burris, almost playing in that football game in 16, but Burris went the distance. So now he gets his chance. First start in a championship for Trevor Harris.
And for Bo, the best winning percentage of any quarterback, and yet there are the critics because he's 1-2 as a starter in this game.
Well, he's the outstanding player that was named on Thursday in the Canadian Football League. He deserved it with completely overhauled receiving core due to injury. He still threw for over 5,000 yards. He has the number one winning percentage in the regular season of any quarterback in CFL history. But you're right, Chris. He is absolutely tired of hearing the question, can you win the big one? They've won, they've lost the last two in a row, and Bo Levi Mitchell wants to change that here tonight.
Yeah, the narratives are different for these two quarterbacks, but both agree it's the biggest game of their careers tonight. Rod?
All right, thank you, CC Suits. And I remember the Week 5 game, and that's what I keep going back to, how dominant the Calgary defense was, Trevor Harris and that offense. That's got to be a big story. I'm curious to see how Ottawa's offense does against Calgary's defense.
And that's big. And I was talking, and I said Trevor Harris would determine how well he played based on the first quarter. And Henry Burris corrected me. You spent hours with him on and off the field. He said it's going to be determined by that first drive. Can he get on that first drive and lead his field down? And he may not need to score, but just have something productive. Maybe get Lewis Ward in field goal range. But if he struggles early, I don't care how dominant he's been over the year. He wasn't dominant against Calgary in those two games. And mentally, he'll revert back to thinking, like, can I actually play well against this team?
Been a great year, 2018, leading up to this point. We saw a lot of clubs, a lot of individual effort, a lot of great efforts by football teams, comebacks and surprises. Absolutely just been a treat to be with you guys, and to watch the two best teams go at it for the next 60 minutes is going to be a treat for all of us across the country. Enjoy the Grey Cup. I don't know how it's going to play out, but I tell you what, this is teed up like no other in a long time. A lot of drama going in this football game.
Well, man, I got to voice the same sentiment because these have become the two class organizations in the Canadian Football League. Here we are, another year, both Ottawa and Calgary. Both of these teams are represented here in the Grey Cup Championship. I'm looking forward to this game because we know both sides have their challenges, but we all know both sides have their strengths.
Yes.
Which one will make the least mistakes will win this game.
Yes.
You know what I'm looking forward to? Said you don't know how it's going to turn out. We're going to predict it anyway. Prediction time, Mr. Steagle.
Well, for me, I was teetering back and forth on who I was going to go for. First it was Calgary, then it was Ottawa. Now it's Calgary, baby. I'm riding a horse, baby. I'm riding the horse.
Milton, I'm right there with you.
You're right there, huh?
I'm going to Calgary Stampeders. Three's a charm. They're going to get it done this year.
Well, that clock has struck midnight, guys, because my gut does say Calgary, but the Grey Cup is made out of plaid. It's coming back to the nation.
Henry, I wonder where you live, Henry. Where do you live, Henry?
Yeah, it's coming back to the nation.
Where do you live, Henry?
We live at the home of the 2018 Grey Cup champion.
I know, better.
I used to live in Ottawa. I'm a proud Ottawa boy, and 2 years ago I predicted the REDBLACKS. You should be glad to hear that, but they're going to hate me in Ottawa today because I'm going with the Calgary Stampeders. Sorry to a lot of my friends.
That took some guts right there, Rod.
James, I know you're also an Ottawa guy. What do you think?
I am, Rod, but I'm a professional broadcaster who is completely unbiased. It's 3-1 right now for Calgary. I say this, Calgary was the best team in the league all year. I talked to Derek Taylor, our analytics guy. He pointed out that Calgary has an advantage in every category. I don't care. I like the hottest team going into the Grey Cup game. The best team in the league last month has been the Ottawa REDBLACKS. I really look goofy in hats, but I'm going for it anyway.
You look good in that one. That's outstanding.
There's a vote for Ottawa.
There you go. You know, guys, I had a chance to be on the sideline for the practice yesterday, for the practice for the two teams, and it was very striking to me, the difference. Completely different approaches. Calgary Stampeders were focused, quiet, subdued. The REDBLACKS were loose. They were having fun. It was like a party on the field. Still businesslike, still focused.
What's that tell you?
But looser. And that's the reason why is because they have a Grey Cup victory. Calgary Stampeders have got a ton of pressure on them. I think that's ultimately going to be their undoing. I am with you, James. Woo.
I'm really concerned about people who are just tuning in this second. And this is the gear we're wearing.
It won't be on all night. I think we look fantastic.
All right, I'm going to do some quick math. It was 3-1 Calgary on the other panel. 2 Red Blacks here, which means that Davis Sanchez will be the deciding vote in our predictions. Let's go, kid.
How'd the rookie get to be the deciding vote?
Yeah, fair enough.
There's a lot of pressure on you now. What you got?
All right, Phil. I've always come through in the clutch, Jocko. I know this much. We don't know what's going to happen if there's adversity with Trevor. This is my deciding factor. We're not sure how Trevor's going to respond if there is adversity. We know Bo's not going to shake with any adversity. He's not going to change Bo. That's why, for me, I'm going to go with also the heartache of this game. I'm an ugly crier. I can't see the Stampeders in that situation to get. I'm going with the Stamps.
There it is. 4-3 for the Calgary Stampeders. It was tight. Pending a recount in Florida, the panel predicts 4-3 for the Stampeders over the Ottawa Redblacks. Tell you what, let's take off these goofy hats, but this is going to be a heck of a football game. Dave Dickinson said after they won the West Final, sorry, Canada, we're back. We know you're sick of us. I'm not sick of the Stamps. I'm not sick of the Redblacks, even though they've been here 3 of the last 4 years, and Calgary's been here 3 straight years. They played one of the best Grey Cups ever 2 years ago. If we can get maybe not a sequel to that, but anything close to that as far as drama, it will be fantastic. This has been a terrific Grey Cup week in Edmonton where they love their football. They love hosting Canada's biggest game. A salute to all the organizers and volunteers and fans here. Their work is done. Now it's the Stamps and the Red Blacks. One trying to end 2 years of heartbreak. The other trying to complete the best 5 years by any expansion team in any sport ever. Settle in, Canada. Our greatest party is next. The 106th Grey Cup, right after this on TSN. Commonwealth Stadium in Edmonton, Alberta, on the last Sunday of November 2018. It's time for Canada's greatest sports tradition and one of its best coast-to-coast parties. It's time for the Grey Cup.
I've been watching Grey Cups since I can remember. Then all of a sudden, here you are in the game, in the Grey Cup. That's a dream come true.
The city's hungry for a championship, and I think they deserve it more than anything in the world.
You set goals at the beginning of the season. Every team sets that goal out to be here for this game.
And to host that trophy up, I think that'll be, you know, the ultimate dream.
Games you live for, you know, big time players make big plays in big games.
We want to make sure that we come out this weekend and just do everything we can to bring the cup home.
Trevor Harris stands alone in CFL playoff history. Did you see that? Touchdown!
See my team running out on the field, everybody jumping up, hugging each other, and I'm seeing that confetti fall in white.
Goodbye, baby! Goodbye!
Welcome to Edmonton and welcome to the 106th Grey Cup game between the West Division champion Calgary Stampeders and the East Division champs, the Ottawa Redblacks. Commonwealth Stadium has seen so many great sporting moments in our history. We hope for another one today. The horse is here from Calgary. The Lumberjacks are here from Ottawa. And we are ready for what promises to be a terrific Grey Cup matchup. Hello, Canada. James Duffy with you, and welcome to Grey Cup 106 from Edmonton, Alberta. These two teams played one of the greatest Grey Cups ever 2 years ago, Ottawa's upset win in overtime. They refused to call it a rematch, too many new faces, but we hope for a repeat of that drama. Let's introduce you to some of the key combatants.
These are the East Division champion Ottawa REDBLACKS, led by quarterback Trevor Harris.
Trevor Harris is painting a masterpiece.
The Ohio native obliterated the postseason history books last week.
A record for Trevor Harris. Sixth touchdown pass of the day.
His 105 passer rating against playoff teams is tops in the CFL this season.
Look out, William Powell!
The heart of Ottawa's ground game was second in the league with 1,362 rushing yards.
Making everybody miss.
Powell forced a record 90 missed tackles in the regular season and leads all running backs with 780 yards after contact.
And Lewis Ward, history maker!
The Kingston native set a pro football record 48 straight field goals.
Record breaker!
The dream season culminated in winning the Rookie of the Year and Special Teams Player of the Year awards.
Welcome, everybody, to the Royal Canadian Air Show.
Ottawa's three-headed receiving monster was unstoppable in 2018. Brad Sinopoli, Greg Ellingson, and Deontay Spencer eclipsed the 1,000-yard mark and have accounted for 19 REDBLACKS touchdowns.
Who else but Brad Sinopoli?
The most outstanding Canadian set a single-season record for receptions by a native son with 116.
You did not do that!
Introducing the West Division champion Calgary Stampeders, led by the league's most outstanding player, Bo Levi Mitchell. Playing with a massive chip on his shoulder, Calgary's signal caller led the league with 35 touchdowns. But in four Grey Cups, he's 1-3, throwing five picks with a completion percentage of 71.3.
Not going anywhere, Alex Singleton.
The heart of the Stamps defense is the Canadian ratio buster. Singleton is the runaway league leader with 123 tackles this year.
Hey, here comes Singleton. I'm tired of this. Wow.
He's also just the second Canadian to record multiple 100-tackle seasons.
John Jackson is running wild.
The CFL's fourth leading rusher in just 13 starts, averaged 71 yards per
game. He's got another gear, and he just showed us.
Jackson also had more than 1,100 yards from scrimmage in his rookie campaign.
Micah Johnson with a big sack.
The punishing force of Calgary's defensive front. Micah Johnson was second in the CFL with 14 sacks, the most by an interior lineman in more than a decade.
Micah Johnson has been dominant.
The Stamps out to end the heartbreak of the last 2 years. Ottawa trying to complete a remarkable first 5 years in the league. The gentleman who will guide you through this game, once again, Chris Cuthbert and Glenn Suter.
Thank you, James. We know that the Stampeders won the two regular season meetings in the first month of the year. I find it interesting that in their last nine meetings between the franchises, we've gone to overtime four times. So with that in mind, Suits, let's take a look at the Nissan Titan keys to the game, brought to you by the Nissan Titan, official vehicle of the Canadian Football League.
Well, let's start with the Ottawa REDBLACKS. They have to establish and commit to William Powell. In one of the games that they lost against Calgary early in the season, when Powell had 123 yards rushing, they have to keep that strong Calgary defense off balance. Defensively for Ottawa, deny the deep ball from Bo Levi Mitchell. He led the league with 42 completions of over 30 yards. For the Calgary Stampeders, Bo Levi Mitchell gave me this yesterday when he said, we've got to finish drives with majors, not field goals, to beat this Ottawa REDBLACKS team. And defensively, Calgary has to collapse the pocket on Trevor Harris. Tough to complete passes from your back.
Thank you, guys. It's definitely a red and black Grey Cup. The Stamps have worn those colors forever. Ottawa put them in their name. One hopes to accessorize with gray in a few hours. The SiriusXM kickoff show and the Rec Laws are next.
Mesdames et messieurs, la LCF est honorée de pouvoir tenir ce match sur les terres ancestrales du traité numéro 6. Provenant de la nation Cree d'Enoch, voici le chef, Billy Morin.
Ladies and gentlemen, the CFL is honored to host this game on the traditional lands of the Treaty 6 territory. Please welcome from the Enoch Cree Nation, Chief Bill Morin.
Miogisigao. Nanaskamau Motai Mao Simantu
Anoskagisagak, Natoki Topi, Sikasan, Muskeg Siko, Chinia. On behalf of my nation, Enoch Cree Nation, let us first give thanks to the Creator for this beautiful day, for this beautiful weather, and for this beautiful setting. My name is Chief Billy Morin from Enoch Cree Nation. On behalf of my nation and Treaty 6 Grand Chief Wilton Littlechild, we bring you welcomings to Treaty number 6. We thank the CFL and Commissioner Randy Ambrosi for allowing this acknowledgement to happen. Treaty number 6 is the traditional homelands of the Cree, the Blackfoot, the Soto, the Stony Nakota, the Dene, and the Métis. And we are proud to share this territory with Gakiel, all Canadians, Albertans, and visitors to this land today. We further give thanks to Amiskwichi Waskayagun, the City of Edmonton, for representing this territory so well in hosting the 106th Grey Cup. We wish luck and a strong game and a safe game to the combatants Ottawa and Calgary. And we wish the Grey Cup and the CFL further success in 2019 as the Grey Cup moves south to our brothers and sisters in Treaty No. 7 territory. Kisagitin, Watstad, Napesis, Nikosis, Xavier, Nota, William, Kinaskumtinawao, Gakiao, Exe, Hi Hi.
The 2018 Grey Cup Kickoff Show was brought to you by Sirius XM Canada. And now the officials for today's game. The head referee from Hamilton, Ontario is Tom Valese, who will be officiating in his third Grey Cup game, his first as head referee.
L'arbitre en match de ce soir provient de Hamilton en Ontario. Tom Valese en est à son troisième match de la Coupe Grey, son premier à titre d'arbitre en chef.
And the rest of the game officiating team. Umpire Richie Miller. Down judge Thomas Cesari. Line judge Justin McInnes. Side judge Jocelyn Paul. Back judge Larry Butler. Field judge Steve Dolinick. Eighth official Ben Major. Backup referee Al Bradbury. Backup officials Rob Hill and Jason Maggio. On September 3rd, Tiger Cat fans delivered the most non-perishable food items this year with over 190,000 pounds. Congratulations, Hamilton. And delivering the Purolator game ball is John Ferguson, president and CEO of Purolator, and Scott Jacobs, Tackle Hunger's longest standing volunteer. Please welcome the Governor General of Canada, Her Excellency, the Right Honourable Julie Payette, the Minister of Science and Sport, the Honourable Kirsty Duncan, and the Lieutenant Governor of Alberta, the Honourable Lois Mitchell. They are joining the team captains and CFL Commissioner Randy Ambrosi for the official coin toss.
Veuillez accueillir la gouverneure générale du Canada, Son Excellence, la très honorable Julie Payette, la ministre des Sciences et des Sports, l'honorable Kirsty Duncan, et la lieutenant-gouverneure de l'Alberta, l'honorable Lois Mitchell. Elles se joignent au capitaine des équipes et au commissaire de la LCF, Randy Ambrosi, pour le tirage au sort officiel.
Gentlemen, we'll be using the special commemorative Grey Cup coin. The Grey Cup logo will be tails. The CFL logo will be heads. Ottawa, your call? Tails. Ottawa has called tails. Your Excellency, would you please do us the honor?
Hello.
It is ahead. Calgary, you've won the toss. You'll defer to the second half. Ottawa, you want the ball? Which end would you like to kick from? As we are receiving. Have a great game, gentlemen.
Rick, last week, Trevor Harris spread the ball so effectively. How critical is it for him tonight to get all your receivers involved?
Yeah, we want to start fast, and we need all hands on deck to get this done, but we've come this far, so why not go a little bit further?
Thanks, Coach. And now with Calgary head coach Dave Dickinson, here's Sarah Orleski.
Coach, you haven't seen Ottawa since week five, but you held them to a combined 17 points in your two regular season games. Your team has changed a lot since then, but is the game plan similar to what worked back then?
We need to have some wrinkles. I mean, we got to try to stop these guys. They're on fire, but I trust our guys. The whole goal is to score one more point than these guys, so let's get it on.
Thank you.
Let's get it on. O Canada is next.
Mesdames et messieurs, veuillez vous lever, retirer chapeaux, tuques et casquettes pour l'interprétation de notre hymne national.
As we welcome members of the Canadian Armed Forces, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, please rise if you can and remove your hats for the singing of our national anthem and a fly past by the Snowbirds. And now, CCMA and Juno Award winner, Alberta's own Brett Kissel.
Oh, Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love in all of us command. Quand on brasse porte le pays, il sait porter la croix. Ton histoire est une épopée des plus brillants exploits. God keep our land glorious and free. Oh Canada, we stand on guard for thee.
Talking is done.
Blown lead by Mitchell, does it again.
4 quarters left in the season.
Touchdown, Ottawa! Record for Trevor Harris.
106th Grey Cup.
Kickoff is next.
It's been 50 years since Russ Jackson led Ottawa to Grey Cup glory over Calgary. It's the 40th anniversary of Commonwealth Stadium and the dawn of an Eskimo dynasty. 20 years ago, Jeff Garcia led Calgary over Hamilton. A decade since Henry Burris engineered the first Stampeder Cup of the Hufnagel era. And 2 years ago, the REDBLACKS claimed their first championship in an overtime thriller against the Stamps. Today, more Grey Cup history to be made. TSN is proud to present the 106th Grey Cup. It's the Ottawa REDBLACKS and the Calgary Stampeders from the Brick Field at sold-out Commonwealth Stadium. Game time temperature zero, as good a day as you could dream of in the Alberta capital in late November.
Two of the first place finishers in their divisions, Ottawa REDBLACKS in the east, Calgary in the west.
And Rene Paredes to kick things off. We're underway. And a bouncing kickoff that will be rolling to the edge. And some good patience there by Deontay Spencer to allow it to roll out. So it's a legal kickoff and good field position for Trevor Harris.
Illegal kickoff out of bounds, Calgary. Ball will be placed at the 45-yard line. First down.
as Trevor Harris gets set to make his first Grey Cup start. He had the six shooter last week and a playoff record up against the only team he's never beaten in the Canadian Football League.
Just three misses in 32 attempts against the Hamilton Tiger Cats in the Eastern Final for Trevor Harris. His first start in a Grey Cup championship with the Ottawa Redblacks.
So after the penalty, they start at the 45-yard line. And they hand it off to William Powell, number two in the league in rushing this year, a man who missed the Grey Cup game in 2016 with injury. He has four on his first carry.
These two teams faced each other early in the season. Calgary won both, but in the first matchup, William Powell had 123 yards rushing in that game. They'll have to have a similar game to keep that good, strong Calgary defense off balance. To do that, you got to contain Micah Johnson. That's in the hands of Evan Johnson, former U.S. Husky, who plays left guard, and Nolan McMillan at right guard.
Second and seven, Harris over the middle, and a ball is dropped. You won't see that often. Greg Ellingson unable to hang on after having his best game of the year last week with 144 yards on eight catches.
Yeah, he was the leading receiver for Ottawa in that Eastern Final, and he's just going to find the seam in the zone. Look, Calgary dropping off early, just flat out dropped it. Good throw from Trevor Harris. Right where it had to be in the open area, really threw him open into that window.
So Terry Williams drops deep, three punt return touchdowns on the year. Richie Leone to punt for Ottawa in his first Grey Cup game. And a line drive kick is fielded by Williams, a 39-yard punt. And Williams is dropped shy of the 30-yard line. A late flag comes down. J.P. Bolduc, one of the Red Blacks captains, down in a hurry.
Major foul, unnecessary roughness. Ottawa number 33, 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
So Dan West, seven-year veteran, gets flagged early. And that will enhance the field position. Ottawa started on their 45, but now Calgary will start on their 44.
Championship game. Take the right of your screen. You'll see Dan West. He just a late hit once the ball carrier and Terry Williams was down. But it can maintain your composure.
Fourth Grey Cup start for Bo Levi Mitchell. And the pressure on early, and he is dropped. J.R. Tavai gets home early for the first sack of the Grey Cup game.
Boy, just straight power rush from Tavai. He's coming from the left of your screen. A little tight end set for Bolt Levi Mitchell to start the first series off for Calgary. He just bowls his way to the quarterback. 7-yard loss for Mitchell.
Here's the look from the ref cam. And just enough to trip up Bo Levi Mitchell. To buy a USC product, his uncle once played for the legendary New Zealand All Blacks. So second and 17 for Mitchell. Has time, has a target, and a first down. And it's big Chris Matthews rolling into Ottawa territory. Finally dropped around a 35-yard line. It's a pickup of 38 for a guy who was almost the Super Bowl MVP a few years back.
Well, certainly he knows the big stage. Chris Matthews played for the Seahawks back in 15, had four for 109 in that Super Bowl against the Patriots, and he knows the theater of a championship game. Comes across the middle, clutch, and second and real long for Calgary in this first series. What a catch over the middle.
Mitchell led the league with 42 passes of over 30 yards on the season. Gets one early for 38 and a first down. And now gets it into the hands of Juwan Breskison, who did not catch a pass in the Western Final, was injured in practice just prior to that game and never was targeted, but he has an early catch here.
Well, Chris, it's been a challenging year, as you know, for the Calgary receiving corps. They had to make changes even this week, so they bring Bakari Grant into the lineup. He has experience in the CFL, 8 years of experience, and in Grey Cup games. Tavares Daniels, a late scratch. Shane Bergen is the most underrated offensive lineman in the league. allowing just three sacks in 3 years.
Back-to-back first downs in the first carry for Don Jackson. And Michael Claussen brings him down. Claussen, a former Stampeder who did not play in last year's game.
Defensively for the Ottawa Redblacks, you won't see a lot of these names up front on the marquee, but collectively they were second in the league in points allowed. They're led by Avery Ellis up front in the D-line, 9 sacks in 2 years. Anthony Choppy in the linebacking core, and Antoine Pruneau is the safety, keeping it together on the back end.
So now 2nd and 7. Mitchell stands in, throws, open target, and intercepted. Jonathan Rose came across and takes it away. And the man with the most interceptions this year in the Canadian Football League has a big one early against Bo Levi Mitchell. There is a flag down. Bo threw 3 2 years ago in the Grey Cup game against the Red Blacks.
Yeah, Bo Levi Mitchell has passed in his 3 Grey Cups for over 300 yards, over 350 yards on average in all 3 games, but has had issues with interceptions.
After the interception, major foul, blindside block, Ottawa number 44. We'll go half the distance to the goal, be first down, Ottawa.
So Tafai with the penalty after the interception by Jonathan Rose, who had one in the Eastern Final and has a big one here early in the 106th Grey Cup game.
Jonathan Rose's man is Chris Matthews. It's going to run a short route here. The corner comes from inside the number 3 receiver, and watch Jonathan Rose fall off of his man, read the quarterback, and Bo Levi Mitchell's throwing motion come back to that deep corner and pick the ball off, taking points off the board in Calgary's first drive.
So after the penalty, Ottawa starts at the 5. William Powell up to the 9-yard line. Micah Johnson, the tackle, a 4-yard run.
Micah Johnson, 14 sacks, 2nd in the Canadian Football League. Unheard of for an interior defensive lineman. Just an outstanding season for the CFL All-Star. Alex Singleton in the middle, 123 defensive tackles for Singleton. Another 100-plus year. And there's the senior statesman in the back end in Brandon Smith.
Stingy's team in points allowed. That pass is knocked down. Looked like it was tipped by Trey Roberson. You saw the feature, Roberson playing on the same stadium in the same big game as his grandfather did for the Edmonton Eskimos, Larry Hybaugh, who won 6 cups.
Well, Roberson is going to do the exact same thing. He's going to fall off his man, and Deontay Spenter is just sitting outside on that out route. He falls underneath the corner and gets his hands on it. That's exactly the same play that Jonathan Rose got his pick for Ottawa.
Stampeders Rookie of the Year, Tunde Adeleke. Terry Williams dropped back with Richie Leone 5 yards deep in the end zone. And he will put it out of there. Launches this beyond midfield, and Williams at his 50, 51-yard punt. And he'll get dropped right at midfield. There's Trey Roberson. Grandpa wore 13, he wears the flip, 31. And just like Larry Hybaugh, he makes a big play in the Grey Cup. Dusk in the Grey Cup City, Bo Levi Mitchell has now thrown 6 interceptions in Grey Cup play.
And there is the contradiction, the best winning percentage ever, but trying to change that Grey Cup stat.
Yeah, and the league's outstanding player got that award on Thursday night, but is tired of hearing that Calgary can't finish.
First quarterback ever to throw over 5,000 yards with no 1,000-yard receiver. Throws the pitch here to Lamar Durant and brought down around the 50-yard line. Tackle made by J.R. Tavai, who's been all over the field.
Well, one of the stats that jumps off the page for Bo Levi Mitchell, especially this year, is that he pushes the ball deep. He's admitted that when he's reading and going through progressions, he starts with the deep ball and then works his way back. His coach as a quarterback, like that high completion percentage, moving the offense intermediate to the deep ball. Five for Durant, second and five. The slant is cut by Breskison and gets wrestled down by Sherrod Baltimore, one of the Red Blacks who was suffering from a flu bug or perhaps food poisoning this week.
Well, this secondary for the Ottawa Red Blacks has got to be great against the deep ball. And already Jonathan Rose has an interception on a deep ball attempt from Mitchell. He led the league with 42 attempts over 30 yards. So Noel Thorpe, the defensive coordinator for Ottawa, understands they've got to be solid on the deep ball. Make Bo Levi Mitchell chip away at it.
And off to Don Jackson and crashing across to Bai again. And he got help from Avery Ellis as the two defensive ends converge on the running back.
Tavai's coming off the edge. A couple of big plays for him early in this Grey Cup. Great backside run down of Don Jackson. Hold him to zero gain there. Samoan descent, played at USC.
Oh, gain second and 10. More pressure on Mitchell. He escapes and throws high and dropped by Durant, who nearly made the circus catch. Mitchell showing you his escapability there when it looked like he might have been dropped for a sack.
And maybe some early nerves for the offenses here. We saw a drop from Greg Ellingson. That's very uncharacteristic. Same for Lamar Durant. Had a chance at that one, and offensively, I think both these teams just trying to settle down a little bit. Had to climb the ladder to go get to it.
We watch Renny Paredes in warm-up not be able to hit from 52, so they're going to punt the ball. Rob Baver will bounce it downfield. O.J. Harris makes the first man miss and steps out at the 17. Still no score. Trevor Harris looking for the initial Red Black first down. A lot of discussion about the field conditions for this game. Let's head to the sidelines here, Sarah Orleski.
Well, Chris, it's certainly been a hot topic over the last couple of days with this field being frozen and very hard. Players concerned about it with respect to footwear. Some came out today, one wearing a cleat on one foot and then a destroyer on the other, with many going with the destroyer. So the destroyer has a spiral bottom, better to be able to grip with. The concern, especially when you look at any area that's painted, I'm told it's very, very slippery. Rob Maver said that this is the first time, he's in his ninth career, this is the ninth season, this is the first time that he has ever worn a destroyer in a game.
And it's the second time that Ottawa will start inside their own 20. A little toss here inside, and Deontay Spencer gets Ottawa its initial first down of the game. Let's check in on the Ottawa sidelines. Here's Matthew Schinetti.
Well, Chris, all week the Ottawa Redblacks have been saying they're not concerned about the field because they played in conditions like this in the East Final. Their offense was so productive. They were wearing those turf shoes. But before kickoff, I overheard Trevor Harris saying this is a really slippery field. Richie Leone, who's wearing a turf shoe and a kicking shoe, said even if you're wearing a turf shoe, it's hard to trust one cleat over the other. Chris.
Of course, conditions a lot better than last year in the snow in Ottawa, and there is a pass batted down. Shakira Davis gets a paw on it. And three incompletions in the game for Trevor Harris, which matches all of last week of the Eastern Final.
Shakira Davis with seven sacks on the season. Had a couple of interceptions from that defensive end position as well. Gets that right paw.
Sacks in the Western Final for the man who succeeded Charleston Hughes. Second and 10. Harris comes down. It is intercepted. Picked off by Ciante Evans. So both interceptions of the game from Nebraska Cornhusker graduates. First it was Rose, and now it's Evans. And it's Calgary football in Ottawa territory.
So far in this first quarter, the field has been tilted in Calgary's favor. They're playing in Ottawa's end. They just can't get out of the hole, and now a turnover. So 1-1 in this game. Ellingson, the intended target, he's the number two receiver right here, who's trying to get that in route. When he makes the cut, it's jumped by Ciante Evans. That's good film study before the game, understanding the route patterns, and jumps it.
So Calgary football at the Ottawa 32. Another quick hitter. Breskison's got another catch. Sherrod Baltimore with the tackle, but Breskison already with three in the game, the Mississauga product.
But offensively, Chris, Calgary wanting to put points on the board in the sudden change. You can build momentum when you do that. Get the turnover from your defense in plus territory. Calgary's got to finish.
Jordanich's team come in with Nick Arbuckle. Second and under a yard to go, and he follows Big Shane Bergman off the left side and has a Calgary first down.
Been a tough year for the receiving core. The starting lineup across the board injured during the season. Eric Rogers missed 9 games of the regular season, but boy, did he have a great Western Final. 3 touchdowns for Eric Rogers and his money in the playoffs. 4 games, over 300 yards, 8 touchdowns in 4 games in the postseason for Eric Rogers, the go-to guy for Bo Levi Mitchell. But it's been tough in that receiving core all year long.
Mitchell back in, first down. Here comes Heath, that'll screen it out. And Don Jackson, open field, touchdown! Touchdown from Bo Levi Mitchell to Don Jackson. That's his first pass receiving touchdown of the season.
There he is, spotlights on him. What a great call by Dave Dickinson. He loads up the wide side of the field with all the receivers, and then he sneaks Don Jackson, his tailback, to the backside into the short side of the field, and he is not covered.
There's a footwear.
We're going to change him right now.
No problem getting to the end zone, but that fall after scoring will make him change. Don Jackson in Mike Riley's locker this week at the Grey Cup game. Maybe that's a little bit of luck, because Mike Riley certainly knows his way to the end zone here at Commonwealth.
Nice play call by Dave Dickinson to get Don Jackson out of the backfield. It's quads to the field. 4 receivers for the Calgary Stampeders to the field, and Jackson's going to sneak out the backside, getting a little blocking help from Chris Matthews. So once he sneaks him out, the Ottawa Redblacks don't count him. Looks like he's going to pass protect, but he doesn't. Gets out of that backfield to the short side of the field, and away he goes with blockers in front of him, untouched to pay dirt. Great call and execution by the Calgary Stampeders.
Stamp scored 51 points against the Redblacks in the regular season, 26 off turnovers, and that's 7 more off the interception by Ciante Evans. So a good start for Calgary. See if Ottawa can get better field position. Here's Deontay Spencer trying to get outside, and he'll be angled out around the 28-yard line. Tonight's game, watching in over 150 countries. ESPN2 in the States, BT Sports in the United Kingdom, and many others. And for the first time, this game being broadcast in Spanish to Mexico, we welcome Aaron Soriano and Frank Beltre, who is getting his first assignment tonight as a color commentator, as they take this game back to Mexico. William Powell straight ahead, and a big run by Powell as he drives
works his way up to the 43-yard line, and that's 15 for Powell. The Stampeders saying the ball came loose, and the officials discussing it.
You see the ball bounce. Yeah, you see it bounce, but was he down by contact before it came out? They're ruling that he was down. Yeah, they're ruling that that was down by contact. Well, now they're going to review it.
So Dave Dickinson is challenging, told us yesterday he would challenge if there were potential points at stake, and in that field position, Calgary would take over.
He just wanted to get clarification, used his challenge flag to do it.
The ruling on the field was forward progress stop. Calgary did not have that information. They've withdrawn their challenge. They will still have their challenge the rest of the game.
Not knowing that that was the call, it would have meant a lost challenge for Dave Dickinson, so they allow him to pick it up. And a reprieve for Trevor Harris and company. First down, and they stay on the ground to Powell. And William Powell, another good run as he drives his way across the 50. Well, that was one of your keys before the game. Can Ottawa establish a ground game with the number two running back in the league this year?
And the running back who missed the final two games of the regular season because Rick Campbell elected to rest him before the Eastern Final.
Lost the rushing title by 8 yards to Andrew Harris. Nine, so second and one back in his hands, and that should be a first down. Coming up on the Freedom Mobile halftime show, Grammy Award winner Alessia Cara takes the stage along with analysis from Rod Henry, Matt, and Milt, and James, Jock, and Davis all coming up at halftime. We saw Davis Sanchez in the pregame show early with Sarah Orleski as a receiver, and he really diagrammed what Jonathan Rose did on the first interception of the game. Play action fake to Powell, but nobody home, and down goes Trevor Harris as Derek Wigan has the sack. Flag down, though, in the Calgary secondary.
Trevor Harris went with play action. He wanted to get the ball to Greg Ellingson off the play action.
Illegal contact. Calgary number 28. 10-yard penalty. The result will be a first down.
Senior statesman in that Calgary secondary in his sixth Grey Cup.
Yeah, he jumped the route by Ellingson and made contact just before the ball arrived. So Devon Claybrooks, the defensive coordinator, regroups on a first and 10 here. But there's Ellingson right here, and watch as he goes and makes that inside cut. You see Sinopoli on the inside, and there's the early contact. Excuse me, Sinopoli, not Ellingson.
First down, they empty it out. Harris, a little double clutch there, but gets it in the flat to the fullback, J.C. Beaulieu.
This is big, though, for Ottawa to get under the hole. They've been playing in that field disadvantage. Calgary having the advantage in field position in this first quarter. Jamie Elizondo, the offensive coordinator, changed things up about midseason for Trevor Harris. He didn't simplify the plays, just the way they called them, so that Harris, when he broke the huddle, could look at the defense from the time he broke the huddle and make his early reads.
Looking at second and four here. Stands in, throwing downfield, and unable to connect with Ellingson. Picked up there by the safety, Adam Berger. So the drive stalls.
But an important one. Important one to grab some field position.
And they're going to try a long Lewis Ward field goal. The kid who was a security guard at last year's Grey Cup game is on the field.
What a season. Outstanding rookie, outstanding special teams player, the Canadian Football League.
Two-time winner, 51 of 52. Pro football record, and from 48 yards out, he has missed. He missed once last week and a couple of converts, and now has missed in the Grey Cup game, and you see the slippery turf. There's Terry Williams. Goes down around the 12-yard line. Well, it was a special morning for us this morning. Our congratulations to the boss, Paul Graham, inducted into the Football Reporters of Canada Hall of Fame. Joining many of the Edmonton legends like Brian Hall in the Hall of Fame. And congratulations from Stuart Johnson, Mark Millier, and all of us who work under Paul Graham. And
absolutely. What a resume for our boss, Paul Graham. Olympics and, of course, the World Juniors, but he has a true love for the game of football in our country.
Ref camp, live mic games, all part of Paul Graham's work. And a handoff inside on the deepest start for Calgary. And the final play of the opening quarter. A couple of interceptions in that first quarter. Offense has had a tough time getting on track, but Calgary able to strike first on a pass and run play to Don Jackson. Seven nothing Calgary after the opening quarter. The 106th Grey Cup, as you check the numbers, and the rushing numbers for Ottawa okay, but certainly not the pass numbers.
They did establish William Powell, got a little bit of the pass game going in that last drive of the first quarter, but it looked to me like both offenses were a little bit nervous and trying to fight some jitters. You know, when you're in the championship game, all the coaches have to do is open the locker room door. You're going to be pumped up for the championship game. You got to control those emotions, and as this game goes on, those offenses will settle in.
Field position was an issue in the opening quarter for Rick Campbell. His team's average field position start the 24, and now trying to flip the field here if the defense can get a stop on Dave Dickinson's offense that looks at second and long from their own 11-yard line. And a procedure call coming up against the Stampeders. Somebody flinched.
Procedure, Calgary number 50 yard. 5-yard penalty. The clock will be held to the snap.
First quarter, the first series, Bo Levi Mitchell was in a second and 10 plus after the sack. Got out of it with a deep throw over the middle to Chris Matthews.
59, Randy Richards, who we're told can get fired up and was a little too fired up on that play. So second and 16. From his goal line, a pump and go down the sidelines and out of the reach of Lamar Durant.
Just got tangled up with Baltimore on the outside, but Lamar Durant had a shot at this. I mentioned how Bo Levi Mitchell will start his progression with the deep ball. If he has a chance to go down the field, he's going to take it. But you can see just right there, Baltimore stumbles into Durant, slows him up just a little bit. No flag on the field.
REDBLACKS did not concede a safety in this situation. Let's see if Calgary handles it the same way. They do. Maver boots it away. Spencer slipped at midfield and now picks it up. But you could see the footing was awful, and Spencer was slow to react to the football because of it.
Well, it starts to get in your head a little bit too once you slip once. Deontay Spencer slipped before he even got the ball in his hands.
And it looks like he's been nicked a little bit as Spencer makes his way to the sidelines.
No yards. Calgary number 3. 5-yard penalty. First down.
So great field position in Calgary territory as Harris rolls, guns down field, and it's caught. Great catch, R.J. Harris over Jamal Wall.
We're going to see Alex Singleton, the new linebacker for the Calgary Stampeders. He has problems with the footing right at the point of attack, trying to get to Trevor Harris. Harris does have the time to get it out there. 22-yard gain by R.J. the other end of that throw.
That Harris connection worked 6 times for 71 yards in the Eastern Final. 22-yard pickup, straight ahead. Powell. And again, yards after contact for William Powell. Another good gain on first down for the Red Black running back.
William Powell studies backs going back in history. His favorite growing up in Texas was Emmitt Smith of the Dallas Cowboys. Big Cowboy fan growing up. But he said he's watched guys like Mike Pringle and admired their game in the Canadian Football League. Guys like Gale Sayers, he goes that back that far and tries to incorporate all of that into his game. He can do it all.
Did you get shivers when he mentioned Mike Pringle? Second down, Harris, a lot of steamboats, and over the middle, incomplete. Intended for the fullback, Beaulieu, but it will be third down, and Lewis Ward will come back onto the field.
Trevor Harris in the Eastern Final used 10 different receivers, accumulating those 6 touchdown passes and completion percentage of just over 90%, a CFL record as well, but still trying to find that groove in this championship.
First bit of adversity in the season for Lewis Ward. Mentioned the misses last week. Slippery field here, but up and through, and the Red Blacks are on the board with that 29-yard field goal. So we're early, second quarter, 106th Grey Cup game. How big an impact will Eric Rogers make after 3 touchdown catches in the Western Final? Saw Deontay Spencer hobble off earlier with an update. Here's Matthew Schinetti.
See, they're working on his knee up to his hip pregame. Deontay Spencer told me the trick on this field was keeping his feet under him. Looking at him right now as he's getting treated on, he's in a lot of discomfort, guys.
Leading all-purpose yardage man in the CFL this year. That'd be a big loss. Calgary takes it at the 35. Play comes down as Mitchell throws, and there's Bakari Grant, just his second game of the year. Grant, the late addition because of all the injuries in that Calgary receiving corps.
Yeah, including this week, Markeith Ambles injured. Bakari Grant in for him.
Offside, Calgary number 15. 5-yard penalty, repeat first down.
Tavares Daniels was very close. But take a look at Bakari Grant, mentioned off the top. He's a veteran of 8 years in the Canadian Football League, 1,000-yard season with Saskatchewan last year. And I know you were wondering all year why he wasn't on a roster somewhere.
I wanted the ATV out, best year of his career. It took till the second last weekend of the year for him to get in the lineup this season. After the penalty, they move back 5, but a connection here to Chris Matthews, another one of those late adds.
You know, for both these teams now, offensively and defensively, with the footing the way it is, they'll continue to experiment with their shoes. And for the offense, they've just got to get to their spot. So it's tougher to make those double moves, tougher to really deke a defensive back. You just got to get to your route. If it's a corner, make one cut, round it off, and get there, which means we're going to see a lot of contested throws in this one tonight.
Back to the original line of scrimmage, second and 10. Mitchell throws over the middle, and he makes a connection with Eric Rogers. Number 15 with a big first down catch up at midfield.
Contested catch because he's got Kyrie Saber on the underneath coverage. Exactly what I'm talking about with the footing. Watch Eric Rogers. He's going to have to banana this route, not really make any sharp cuts or moves. Just get to the spot on the field where Bo Levi Mitchell can hit him.
It's a 21-yard gain, but look, Kyrie Saber right in his hip pocket, and Rodgers wins the battle.
Had knee surgery midway through the year. And the Stamps were really concerned of whether or not Rodgers could play in back-to-back games, but after what he did last week in the Western Final, he is in back-to-back, and now Chris Matthews is getting attention.
Dave Dickinson told us DeVaris Daniels was very close, but he had a collarbone injury, and with a collarbone, you can't test it full in practice. So he said he was unsure, and with Eric Rodgers still not 100% and may not being able to finish this game, he couldn't take the chance on both of them not being able to finish. That's why Bakari Grant drew into the lineup for DeVaris Daniels.
Chris Matthews trying to hit back into the huddle, but he's out for three plays. And Julon Lynch comes in to take his spot. University of Saskatchewan product. So at midfield, first down, Don Jackson. Not much up the middle as he gets stacked up. And in the middle of it is Kyrie Saber, the 38-year-old, the last Renegade, a guy who started his CFL career with the Ottawa Renegades back in 2004.
Kyrie Saber plays on the edge, but when I asked defensive coordinator Noel Thorpe about him, he said, boy, I'm proud to coach this guy. Nine different cities in two leagues throughout his career, over 600 tackles. He disrupts plays.
18-year pro looking for his first Grey Cup. Second and nine. Mitchell's got time. And an open target. And there is Lynch with a catch. Only two receptions during the regular season, both in a game against the Toronto Argonauts. And here he delivers a 26-yard reception in the Grey Cup game.
Well, you nailed it, Chris. Lots of time for Mitchell in the pocket. He has time to go through those progressions. Take a look. No play action here, but no pressure on him at all. Nice throwing lane to step up in there right on the logo at midfield to find Lynch on the sideline. Got a good group up front with Derek Dennis, CFL PA All-Star, voted on his peers at left tackle. And I mentioned Shane Bergman at left side is solid.
That's a first down. Looks like they're setting up the screen inside. And Durant unable to make a catch. I wanted to ask you, Slippery Field, as a former defensive back, did you feel like you were at a big disadvantage?
It changes your technique because it's hard to redirect. So if you're going to play off a receiver like Lamar Durant or Eric Rodgers, you've got to try and redirect when he makes his break. What you can do is change your technique and go to more of a press coverage, so you're in there running with the receiver stride for stride from the get-go.
Second and 10, Ottawa shows pressure. Quickly out of the hands of Mitchell, and Rodgers has the catch. Shrugs off first contact and surges ahead close to what appears to be a Calgary first down.
He fights for extra yards here. Mitchell wants the next play so he can get him up on the line of scrimmage. Sometimes you don't have to run full speed, and another slip from Rodgers, but he gains control. Look at him battle for an extra yard or two.
6'3", 215, showed you his strength there. Calgary had issues in the red zone this year, but they've scored on each of their last five trips. Terry Williams in the backfield. First and 10, Calgary. Three-step drop, and now Mitchell's got to take off. Looking for Durant. Got it. Is it a touchdown? Yes. Touchdown, Lamar Durant.
Bo Levi Mitchell told me yesterday when I asked him, what must you do to win this game against a hot Ottawa football team? He said, we've got to finish drives with touchdowns. This is big in that regard, but also for Lamar Durant, who had a couple of drops, one in the first quarter, one just a few moments ago. That's a big one for his confidence as he stretches across the goal line.
Command center has confirmed the touchdown. Durant had one in 2016. Out of Centennial Secondary in Coquitlam. And into the end zone in the Great Cup game for his second championship touchdown. Rene Paredes adds the convert. 14-3 Stampeders. So Bo Levi Mitchell has thrown a pair of touchdowns in this game. First to Don Jackson, now to Lamar Durant.
Lamar Durant, nice bang route on Jonathan Rose. And watch how carefully he runs this route with the bad footing as he's going to go on an inside cut. Jonathan Rose choosing to play off him and playing coverage. Now he has trouble redirecting on that bang route to the outside. The ball is thrown out in front of him. And Durant makes amends after a couple early drops.
So advantage Rose early in the game, but now Durant, LaMarvelous, comes back with a touchdown grab. And here's R.J. Harris taking the spot of Deontay Spencer, and he will not reach the 30-yard line. Well, we mentioned Aaron Soriano and Frank Beltre are here broadcasting in Spanish. Here's how Mexico heard that last call.
Allá va moviendo a su ofensiva con tiempo para lanzar, mucho tiempo, compra un poco más el pase, este no lo iba a desperdiciar y es touchdown para
Suits, we might be in trouble.
Outstanding.
Valarin Arimolade in for Jagaris Davis, play action fake, and Trevor Harris is now 3-for-10, the man who led the CFL in pass percentage at 70.1 is at 30% here in the first half.
Well, accuracy from the quarterback is so important, Chris, especially with the footing the way it is, because it's tougher for the receivers to redirect to the ball if it's a little behind them or a little short.
Well, this offense hasn't got any traction yet. Second and 10. Four-man rush. Got some time. And that one almost picked off. Emmanuel Davis. A good break on the football. It's the third, two and out. The intended target was Deontay Spencer back in. And he argues that there was no call on the play.
Devon Claybrooks, the defensive coordinator for Calgary, who will be sought after as a possible head coach in the league, has already made an adjustment because of the field. He is playing more zones, allowing his DBs to just back off and then break on the football when it's thrown.
Derry Williams back with a slick field effect punt cover. Williams with three punt return touchdowns during the year. 34-yard punt. And the Redblacks down in a hurry. Flag on the play. We will sort it out when we come back. A pair of touchdown passes for Mitchell in this first half. In its fifth year, the Nissan Kickoff Project has supported 4,300 athletes at 78 schools across Canada. 70 athletes chosen for their work on and off the field for the first ever Nissan All-Canadian Titan game. It took place here in Edmonton yesterday at Clark Field, and our congratulations to Team Midnight, who beat Team Pro 4X 24-19. There they are. Also, congratulations to the Vanier Cup champion, Laval Rouge-Or. And belated congratulations to the now five-time Canadian junior champs, the Saskatoon Hilltops. And yesterday in the CFL-NFL flag football game, it was the Montreal Flight School dominating action for a national championship. Who wins the big game here? It's a 14-3 Calgary lead. And Mitchell throwing. Rogers, does he have the grab? Looks like he does. holds on for a catch across the 35.
Favorite target in this one's become Eric Rogers. No surprise there.
7 yards. Second three, St. Peter's on their own 37-yard line.
Dickinson trying to keep balance in the offense as well. That's why we've seen healthy diet from Don Jackson. But they want to keep Ottawa's defense off balance.
Seven for Rogers, his third catch of the game. Sets up second and three. And they run the jet. It's Picari Grant with it, and he gets cut down. Defensive play made by Rico Murray, the top defensive player for the Redblacks on the season.
Gets a good spot here.
First down.
Sorry, Chris. He gets a good spot here up to the 40-yard line, which should move the chains. It looked like when he was cut down, he was about a yard short, but got the benefit of the doubt from the officials and a new set of downs for Bo Levi Mitchell.
Last possession for Calgary, an 8-play, 75-yard touchdown drive. First and 10 here from their 40. Pressure coming, gets it away, it's intercepted. It's Sherrod Baltimore with the pick. Heading west and getting brought down at the 39-yard line by Durant. But it's the second interception of this first half by the Ottawa Redblacks.
Interceptions have got Mitchell in trouble in past Grey Cups. And it looked like a communication issue between he and Chris Matthews, who was running a straight go route alongside Eric Rogers, and he threw it believing that Matthews was going to break on an inside cut there. Sherrod Baltimore wasn't fooled. He sat on the throw.
And one in the Eastern Final, three for the Redblacks last week, and now two in the opening half. Bully by Mitchell, now seven interceptions tossed in Grey Cup play. And William Powell with a carry for seven, setting up second and manageable for Ottawa.
Mitchell working it out with that receiving core. Again, it's changed almost game to game. I don't understand where the communication problem was between he and Matthews, but this is sudden change opportunity for Ottawa.
Quarterback coach Ryan Dinwiddie. Ottawa scored a couple of times on the opening play after a takeaway last week. Here they grind out a first down on the carry by Powell.
Jimmy Elizondo going with William Powell. Back-to-back plays here in plus territory to just continue to feed the star tailback the football and control the line of scrimmage in doing it, because on that line of scrimmage is Micah Johnson. I haven't mentioned him much yet, but we talked about him all year long. An all-star.
With Powell, he carries 51 yards so far. Those orange shoes have some traction as he pumps it outside. But that ball popped loose. Who's got it? Looks like a Rivelade came up with it and has taken it away for the Stampeders. Jameer Thurman looked like he was able to separate Powell from the football.
Powell has it in the football in his right arm, and that's where the contact is coming from. It's Jameer Thurman who strips it out. You're right, Chris. Recovered by Calgary. Sudden change to sudden change. Muscling to the football pays off.
So Powell had one come out at the whistle earlier in the game, and now gives up another. Just one fumble lost during the regular season, but a huge takeaway for Calgary to get the ball right back.
Even professionals at times will have that lapse in judgment. That ball should have been in the other arm.
So they trade turnovers here, and Mitchell gets a reprieve and sets up the screen, but Don Jackson unable to pull it down. It'll be second and 10. But not just a turnover, one in scoring territory for the Redblacks. And Arimelade came up with it, replacing Jagera Davis, who has been getting attention on that Calgary bench.
Jameer Thurman making the play, Chris, to strip the ball out of there from William Powell. What a season Thurman has had. One of the great young linebackers in the Canadian Football League out of Indiana State.
one of my candidates for most underrated player in this league. Second and 10. On time. Anybody home? Underneath it goes, and Don Jackson is wrestled down immediately by Kai Bear. So the Red Blacks defense doesn't flinch, forces Calgary to punt as we hit the 3-minute warning, but Ottawa unable to take advantage of that last Mitchell interception.
It's time I let you go.
Coming up on the Freedom Mobile Halftime Show, Grammy Award winner Alessia Cara takes the stage, along with analysis from Rod Henry, Matt, and Milt. And we'll also hear from James, Jock, and Davis, all coming up at halftime. Have I mentioned that Alessia's from Brampton? Make sure you got that suits.
Looking forward to that halftime show. Big play there to Kyrie Saber to track down Don Jackson. Get the ball back for Ottawa.
Spencer back just inside the Ottawa 50. And Rob Neighbor lets it fly. 44-yard punt. Spencer on the return, and he skips out of bounds in Calgary territory around the Stamp 53. A week ago, Trevor Harris was 29 of 32. 367 yards, 6 touchdowns. A much different story here tonight.
Different defense.
Back-to-back starts around midfield, and open receiver here is Julian Fioli. Gadito getting away, and it's the Carr touchdown. What a spectacular play by the Laval product for 55 and a touchdown.
Just one catch in the Eastern Final for Fioli Gadito. This will be the biggest of his career so far, and he's been in the Canadian Football League for 7 years. What a play.
10 years ago, he had a touchdown in the Vanier Cup for Laval. This one, much bigger than that.
Secures the football on contact, battles for the extra 2 yards to cross the goal line.
Talk about unlikely heroes. 11 catches during the regular year. 2 touchdowns in the game. And these replays show you that ball did break the plane. Although we were waiting for command center confirmation, and we're told that it has been confirmed. 55-yard play, his biggest as a Red Black. Was on the practice roster of the Argos back in 2012 when they beat Calgary in the 100th Grey Cup game. Well, that changes things.
Love to go for two. Gone for two more than any team in the CFL.
17 of 23 in these two-point attempts. Trying to make it a three-point game, and they'll take it to Powell. Open target, and Beaulieu has it. And now 18 of 24, almost automatic on the two-point converts, and Jamie Elizondo is fired up at the momentum change of the game.
Yeah, Jamie Elizondo said to us yesterday that this team is a one-go, we-go type of team. And that they're all going to chip in. Mentioned in the Eastern Final, 10 different receivers. J.C. Beaulieu, who just caught the two-point convert, had a touchdown on a corner route in the Eastern Final. Brendan Galanders on a screenplay. A touchdown for him. Boy, and that validates what they've been coaching and teaching all season long in Ottawa, that everybody chips in. 1 of 12. Do your job. Everyone wins those personal battles. Win enough of those, you win the game. That's a big, big touchdown. Fioli Gadino. They're right back in it.
Leone kicks it off. Terry Williams with the return. He'll get taken down just across the 35-yard line. So a pair of touchdown passes for Bo Levi Mitchell, but two more interceptions for a guy who has averaged 366 yards in his Grey Cup starts.
Yeah, he's got big numbers yardage-wise. Of course, a champion in 2014 when they played against Hamilton in Vancouver. After back-to-back losses, and interception's an issue there. Back to running the offense and just settle down here.
Hadn't thrown an interception in the previous three games. And hand it off here. Doug Jackson, big hole. And he powers his way across midfield into red-black territory with his best run of the game. It's a 19-yard scamper.
Boy, you can catch defensive linemen and take advantage of the field conditions because Avery Ellis could not redirect to make this play and opened up a running lane for Don Jackson.
Into red block territory at the Ottawa 54. Now they screen. Jackson able to pull it off his shoe tops. And good contact made there as Jonathan Rose went low on Don Jackson.
Take a look at the right side of the offensive line for Calgary here. They're going to wash down the Ottawa defense, but watch the outside. He can't redirect inside to get to that play because of the field conditions. It was Avery Ellis.
Got 7 second and three. I know you're a music guy, and Don Jackson, a hip-hop recording artist. Second and three, Warner Jackson nearly intercepted as Matthew slipped and Jonathan Rose almost double dipped. Well, you know the story, suspended after the Eastern Final for pushing an official. Rose only in this game because the appeal has not been heard. And a big break for Ottawa and a break there by Mitchell that he didn't throw a third interception.
Well, Mitchell has to get rid of the football here, Chris, because he's throwing it to the spot where Chris Matthews is supposed to end up, but Matthews just went down on the break.
There's R.J. Harris, stepped out. And a 44-yard punt by Maver has pinned Ottawa. One of the toughest guys on our crew.
Yes, sir.
Leslie Butreau was run over last year in the Grey Cup game. He started, didn't finish. Good to see him back on the sidelines this year.
Take a hit and come right back for the next year's Grey Cup. Love it, Lee. Good work, my friend. Want to also mention a guy who does great work all year long. Those great ISOs you see, we call him DB. Dennis Beluyat, that's why we call him DB.
Yeah, there's a reason for that.
Does a great job with our ISOs.
All the guys in the truck.
Yeah.
And gals. And a catch made here. There's Brad Sinopoli, top Canadian in the league for the second time. And a record setter this year with 116 catches, third in the league in yards, and his first grab goes for 25.
Thursday went up against Andrew Harris for top Canadian in the CFL and won the award, and it was a pickup.
Yeah,
between those two this year.
Outstanding years for the leading rusher and the leading pass catcher. Both Canadians. Harris has got a scramble out of the pocket there. It is dropped by Junior Turner just across the 40-yard line.
Number three in the league in receiving. Brad Sinopoli, 116 catches. Four more than Ben Cahoon in 2003.
And a guy who started as a quarterback in Calgary, playing in his fifth Grey Cup game, 2-2. In the big game, second down, and the catch is made there. Sinopoli holds on. And the Peterborough product moves the sticks.
And it looks like Trevor Harris is getting that accuracy back.
Well, it's really getting even statistically as well. Calgary 201 net yards. And now Ottawa up to 191. And a first down here in the final minute. Got time to maybe tie it or even take the lead. Powell over the backfield. Roberson ushers him out of bounds.
Another positive for Ottawa going in after the scores. They still have time to line up for a field goal if they can get a chunk here. Their offensive line has kept Micah Johnson at bay so far in this first half. Johnson, of course, will be working against the double team every play.
Powell, 62 yards from scrimmage. Second down, and the pass for Spencer broken up. There's Roberson on the scene again.
That's a sweet breakup. Roberson coming out of his back pedal.
Grandma watching in Indianapolis tonight, proudly.
Asked Devon Claybrooks about Roberson, he said because of his past as a quarterback, he reads the field and the receiver's routes like a quarterback would. And it gives him that split second jump. Rookie of the Year nominee for the Calgary Stampeders.
Bill Leone punts it. Dying seconds, first half. And Terry Williams trying to get away. Terry Williams got away. Look out. He may be gone. Three Pemberton touchdowns during the regular season. And what is the biggest game of the year? First Pemberton touchdown in the Grey Cup game since 1996. Six is off and running on the Commonwealth Stadium sidelines.
And fresh legs for Terry Williams, who did not play in the Western Final. Romar Moore has got the call there, was injured in that game. Williams has fresh legs, jump in his step, and is gone on the punt return.
Not on the roster a week ago. Some suggestion he may require surgery when the season is over, but it's all right if nobody touches you. And Terry Williams goes untouched for a Grey Cup record, 97-yard punt return. Convert good. Jimmy the Jet Cunningham had a 96-yarder for the Argos in the snow in Hamilton in 96. Terry Williams just bested him and has restored a two-score Calgary lead.
Well, not a lot of moves. He makes a couple right when he catches the football, but he got some help from the other 11 blocking for him in front. Williams uses his speed once he gets halfway through the return to outrun Richie Leone. Great Cup record, 97-yarder. Of the returners in the regular season that had 50 returns or more, he had the best average at over 13 yards a return. And Chris, you mentioned the three touchdowns.
Some Ottawa fans will remember Bill Hatnaka's return. A big one in the 76 game. But the Red Blacks had got back in it, and all they had to do was cover a punt to go to the locker room, probably feeling pretty good about themselves, and Terry Williams changes all that in a hurry.
Well, does Deontay Spencer have the answer? Does R.J. Harris have the answer? Calgary may try and squib this with just a second go in the first half.
Yep.
No driver.
It is Harris. He's going to toss it back or not. Holding on to it pretty loosely and brought down across the 40-yard line. That's going to do it in the opening half. What a way to finish with that 97-yard touchdown run by Terry Williams. It was Ottawa by 13 at the half 2 years ago. It's Calgary by 10 as we join Matthew Schinetti.
Trevor, we know how explosive this offense could be. What is it going to take in the second half?
Us to just stay in rhythm. We started getting a nice little rhythm toward the end of the half. We just got to stay in rhythm, be able to move the chains, stay on the field, and be able to use our tempo.
Thanks, Trevor. Now with Eric Rogers, let's send it over to Sarah Orleski.
Eric, what does that do for this group to have that Terry Williams touchdown and give you guys a 10-point lead heading into the half?
It's huge. You know, Ottawa, they took momentum with that double move touchdown, and Scary Terry made a play at the end, kept his footing, and outran everyone. That was huge.
How bad is the footing out there? Fair enough.
Thank you.
Hey,
Coming up on the Freedom Mobile Halftime Show, Grammy Award winner Alessia Cara takes the stage. And we'll also have analysis from Rod, Henry Matt, and Milt, as well as Jeeves Duthie with Jock Climie and Davis Sanchez. It's all coming up at halftime.
James Duffy with you back at the 106th Grey Cup at Commonwealth, where conditions are perfect except the field. Footing has been an absolute nightmare for both sides, except Terry Williams on this 97-yard return that has the Stamps up 21-11. Hello again, Canada. James Duffy with you. The halftime show is here, brought to you by Freedom Mobile. We'll have tons of analysis from Rod Smith in the panel, plus Jock Climie and Davis Sanchez at my side. Talk about these conditions and the footing and how both teams will have to adjust. But up next, Canada's own Alessia Cara will be here. Oh, here. Oh, here. We'll hope her footing is better on the stage. Alessia's next. James Duthie back with you. Your halftime statistics. Ottawa, woeful start, but they've evened things up. Only 6 yards difference in net yards. Rod Smith and the boys.
All right, thank you, James. Along with Henry Burris, Matt Dunnigan, and Milt Stegall. Momentum swings, turnovers in this game, and yes, a very slick playing surface. The biggest momentum swing right at the end of the half. Just when it looked like Ottawa had a chance to come in and tie this football game, they're forced to punt. Now, slick field could be a factor here too, but there's something else. What about Ottawa's punt coverage and the Terry Williams touchdown?
Well, definitely on that touchdown, 97 yards, a new CFL record. To me, I don't think the surface played a role in this. If you take a look at this, one thing about special teams is you got to play your lane. Three different Ottawa Redblacks there on the left are in the same lane, which leaves a hole open. Charlie Powers there, number 46, delivered the block, which sprang Terry Williams. And once you get a guy like Terry Williams with his speed, he's a north-south runner. He was off to the races, just like 100 meters. Sprint, touchdown, Calgary.
Undisciplined play right there. You talk about Terry Williams. He returned three for touchdowns in a regular season, and undisciplined play on that slick surface, that's what's going to happen to you. They have to be disciplined in the second half.
No question, Milt. It's like an ice rink out there, and vertical play is the key of the game. We saw it in the first half on so many different plays, and this surface has just got awful right now, and these guys are really struggling big time to try to keep their footing. We've seen players hurt right here. I thought Deontay Spencer, the intern, hurt himself right there. He actually went to the sidelines, was out for about two series of plays, and it just gets ugly when you get on the paint as well. There's no footing there whatsoever. Any type of vertical play, as you mentioned, Hank, any type of north-south running, any type of north-south moves, you don't have to double move people. Yeah. Just run by them because they're flat-footed and they can't get off the mark. It's been Canadians that are making an impact in this game, right, and I find that interesting because of the surface, they're used to it. You got Julian Fioli-Godino for the Ottawa Redblacks, John Christophe Ballou. You got Julian Lynch, Lamar Durant making big plays. A lot of Canadians stepping up in these conditions.
Yeah, and you talk about Bo Levi Mitchell. When he gets out there and play, he understands this may be his last chance for his legacy. And he's had a solid game. You know, he's missed some plays, but he had some receivers make some plays for him. And this is what you want out of your starter. You want him to get to the ball and to his ball handlers and allow him to make some plays. He threw some interceptions, but you know the one thing I like, and Matt and I were talking about this, Lamar Durant, he had a couple of drops. A lot of times, quarterbacks are going away from him, but Bo trusts his guy. He allowed him to get his confidence back up, make that touchdown, and that's going to pay dividends in his second half.
Well, you know, the field conditions, remember the Stamps coming off, they weren't happy yesterday. Alex Singleton, Bo Levi Mitchell. You're at Eric Rogers with Sarah Oleski. It is what it is, but both teams, as they point out, have to deal with it, James.
All right, back with three-time 1,000-yard receiver Jock Climie, three-time Grey Cup champion Davis Sanchez. Besides the footing, what did Calgary do to contain Trevor Harris early, and how did he adjust in that second quarter?
Yeah, in the pregame show, I talked about the key being taking away Trevor Harris's first read. That's what the Calgary Stampeders do better than anybody, and this is what happened right here. They took away his first read in the football.
They have a reputation, this Stampeders secondary, for staring down the quarterback and taking chances, and that's what he did right there.
And now you saw him for the rest of the half. He was struggling. He went two. Off to his third read, he's thrown off his back foot, and finally he figured it out. He realized, you know what, let them jump my first look, and then go over the top.
Yes,
and this is another touchdown half.
Yeah, Ciante Evans, the first look was the out route by the inside receiver. Ciante Evans stopped his feet and looked at that, and boom, Trevor Harris finally took advantage of that and went deep.
This is something we're going to have to look for in the second half. The Calgary Stampeders, we know, are going to want to continue to do this, but he's a rhythm passer. Trevor Harris loves to throw on time in rhythm, and we haven't seen much pass rush because they've been confusing him. It's that disguised look that has been causing him trouble.
They really had some rhythm going, but that Terry Williams punt return right now is the favorite for TSN Turning Point copyright, but still 30 minutes left to change that. The second half just ahead here on TSN.
TSN is proud to present the 106th Grey Cup. Here comes he to the screen of it. Buck Jackson, open field, touchdown. Now Mitchell's got to take off, looking for Grant. Got it. Touchdown, open receiver here, touchdown. What a spectacular play. Look out, he may be gone. Quick six is off and running.
To hear the Reclaws, Alessia Cara, and more great music, check out the official CFL Grey Cup playlist exclusively on Apple Music.
Here we go, Calgary led by 9 at the half. They have a 10-point lead in the 2018 Grey Cup game as we get set for the second half.
Bo Levi Mitchell, 14 of 21, 182 in that first half. Matty mentioned at halftime, touchdown throw to Lamar Durant was a big one, both for the team at the time and also Durant's confidence. Number one receiver really has been Eric Rogers in that first quarter. Trevor Harris had a tough first quarter, but has rebounded. As he mentioned going in at halftime, found some rhythm in the second.
Just 6 yards of net offense, the difference. But the big difference, the 97-yard punt return for Terry Williams. And a good kickoff return to start the second half as Williams across the 40-yard line.
Return by number 38.
First half for Bo Levi Mitchell. I mentioned his numbers. That was second and 10 plus in the first drive of the game to hit Chris Matthews. Guys talked about the footing being a bit of a challenge. Eric Rogers became his number one target. Don Jackson on that little dump pass over the middle was a great call by Dave Dickinson in the first half. There's Lamar Durant's touchdown. He also had a couple of picks. Wants to avoid that in the second.
Stamp start at their own 42. And Mitchell over the middle. It's a catch for Preskison. Quickly taken down by Chaffee. And with that first half production, only by Mitchell, now number 4 all time in Grey Cup yardage.
Pretty big names on that board. Anthony Calvillo, Ricky Ray, Doug Flutie.
And if he gets to 335 on the day, he will be number 2 all time. Not what he came here for.
No.
Second and 5. And again over the middle, it's Rogers to catch right in front of Rico Murray and the middle linebacker, Avery Williams.
No, not what he came here for. What he came here for is to end the questioning, end the comments.
people saying that the Calgary Stampeders are a real good regular season team. 13 wins this year, 13 wins last year, 15 wins in 16. That team was overconfident. This team is not. They respect the Ottawa Redblacks. They know they're going to have to dig for 60 minutes to get the win.
And they admitted this week they were overconfident.
Yes.
That wasn't your assessment. It was the assessment of many, like veteran Brandon Smith. And off Don Jackson again, straight ahead. And a run close to a first down for the Calgary running back. 5 for 22 in the first half.
Shane Bergman, Ecombre Williams. Watch them open it up in the middle up front for Don Jackson. I asked Don Jackson how he described his running style this week. He said, I run violent. So that's interesting you say that, because that's how I've used to describe it all season long.
Second and inches, so Arbuckle in. See if they have anything on here. Arbuckle straight ahead behind Ducombre Williams. Brad Erdos. And a first down.
Now I'm that conversation with Jackson, and I asked him about his average. His average was the same as Andrew Harris. Didn't get as many touches or playing all the games this year due to injury. And he said, you know, all I work for is that when I go home to watch the video, I know that every single play was full speed. And all I try to gain is the respect of my teammates and my coaching staff. You do that, you're going to be a good football player. And Don Jackson is a great football player.
Calgary first and 10 at the Ottawa 45. Short drop pass for Matthews. And there's Choppy on the scene once again. Limiting the game. And a late penalty. Post-whistle penalties will drive the coaches crazy at any time of the year, but in particular in this game.
Rico Murray is trying to come down.
After the play, major foul, unnecessary roughness. Calgary number 81, 15-yard penalty, second down.
Veteran Rico Murray was telling his teammates, it's against them. Don't get involved in the stuff after the whistle. Take a look at Chris Matthews. What does he do here? Ooh, little elbow shot.
Costly 15.
May have been something said in that exchange as well.
Came after the gain, so second and 19. And they'll swing it out to the flat. McCurry Grant can't hold on. And another flag.
I think this is going to go against Calgary as well. I think it's holding up front.
Holding. Calgary number 59. That penalty is declined. Third down.
Randy Richards, it's going to be declined, so the punt team comes on. Second fewest penalties in the league this year. Assessed against Dave Dickinson's crew.
There's a lot of football to be played, but that's an important stop early. The Calgary Stampeders won the toss and deferred to the second half with a 10-point lead. They score again. They get all the momentum.
Rob Meaver, good boot inside the 10. R.J. Harris with the back. Does he have a crease? Finally brought down across the 20-yard line to improve the field position today. And delegate the Carlton product on the tackle. And now Trevor Harris hoping to continue the momentum he started to generate late in that opening half as the Redbacks trail. Close to 60,000 on hand at Commonwealth. A tale of two quarters for Trevor Harris in that opening half.
Yeah, really struggled in the first half with just 17 passing yards, but found a rhythm in the second quarter. Got right back into it until the punt return from Terry Williams.
Well, they start just beyond the 20-yard line. And Harris has Ellingson. A catch made short of the first down around the 30. That's the first catch of the game for Greg Ellingson, a 1,000-yard receiver, number 6 in the league during the regular campaign. Three of the top 9 receivers in the league this year in this Ottawa attack, and the Buds, Ellingson and Sinopoli, have combined for 3 catches so far tonight. Second and short, Powell off the left side. Singleton the tackle, a first down, and you can see William Powell has changed his footwear. After wearing the bright orange, those look more like broomball shoes here in the second half. I'm not sure they are, but
did anyone have staple guns in the locker rooms?
Those certainly aren't as funky as the orange ones, but well, a key last year for the Argos was a change of footwear at halftime in the snow in Ottawa. And here's Powell again. He's run hard tonight. Up close to the 40-yard line, and he has close to 7 more.
Yeah, but smart for Jimmy Elizondo, offensive coordinator. Stay committed to the run game. Stay committed to keeping that defense a little bit off balance for the Calgary Stampeders. If you become one-dimensional against Micah Johnson and that group up front, it's a long night. He knows that. That's what's important about keeping Powell involved.
Second and 3, they stay on the ground. And Powell's got a big hole. Second level across the 50. And William Powell gives Ottawa a fresh set of downs.
RJ Harris, young receivers watching. Sometimes you got to get your nose dirty, kids. And this is one of the examples right here, is he's going to come out and get a kickout block. RJ Harris, that slot back from the left of your screen all the way across. Nice kickout block there to cut down on Cordero Law. A 12-yard gain off that block for William Powell.
12 yards for Powell. Stay with him. And dropped around the 54. Cordero Law makes the tackle. His third great cap game for the Stamps, looking for his first win.
Right now, Evan Johnson, former Husky, and Nolan McMillan are controlling the interior of Devon Claybrook's group. That offensive line, the tackles, and Alex Mateus at center. I mean, we haven't talked a lot about Micah Johnson and his 14 sacks in the regular season.
Second and 8. They throw. Quick hitter, and it's caught. RJ Harris got loose. And he's still going. Waiting for an Ellingson block, and finally out in Calgary territory as RJ Harris has his second catch.
Jamar Wall had a shot at this football. And defenders right now, like the guys talked about at halftime, they're taking their shot because they know they can't redirect if they miss. They're just taking their shot at the ball, and if you miss it, it's a big play the other way. RJ Harris.
And you saw Wall slip slide away after it. Back into the hands of Powell, cracking off the left side. Roberson brings him down. Good looking drive for the Redblacks here to start the second half.
Well, you just got to stick with it and not let this, the footwear and the field conditions, get in your head. I don't care if you're a defensive lineman trying to get a push on an O-lineman, receiver trying to make a break, DB trying to redirect to get to that receiver. Don't let it get in your head.
He played the drive, a fake to Powell on a roll, looking downfield, and incomplete. Unable to connect with Ellingson, who looked like he had a half step on Emmanuel Davis.
He did, just led to the boundary. And Trevor Harris knows that one got away on him. Boy, he had him. He had a step on him, you're right, on Ciante Evans, and just threw it a step out of bounds. Excuse me, Emmanuel Davis.
So from 41 yards out, Lewis Ward in his first Grey Cup game. And good, and it's a 7-point Calgary lead. Harris for points on the board with Ottawa's first possession of the second half. Our congratulations to RDS colleague Pierre Fercheval, winner of the Commissioner's Award for his service to the Canadian Football League as a a player, now a commentator, along with David Arsenault for RDS calling the game tonight. By the way, Arsenault has the best depth charts in the league.
Well, Pierre Versevol, I realized in his acceptance speech that he is a teammate of Randy Ambrosio, commissioner of the league, and a special shout out too for the Hugh Campbell Leadership Award, which went to Wally Buono. End of a tremendous career for Coach Buono.
Neat moment at the awards when they had everybody stand up whose career in some way had been impacted by Buono, and by the end of it, everybody in the theater was on their feet for the Godfather. And we say hello to him watching tonight. A little different watching now, huh?
Well, he can put his feet up and relax. Hugh Campbell Leadership Award, and Hugh is here to support Rick on the sideline.
And our scouting report is that Hugh Campbell is pretty nervous.
Yes, he was.
Interesting. Second and four here. Mitchell with time to swing it out. And it's Jackson down the sidelines. And up for a first down. Since the last Bo Levi Mitchell interception, there's been a three punts for Calgary. So they're trying to get back in a groove on offense.
Yeah, I think Noel Thorpe, Chris, has made an adjustment here at halftime to play more zone. You see the zone drops. Now, with Bo Levi Mitchell having that kind of time, he can look to find holes in that zone. This time it's a swing pass to Don Jackson.
Terry Williams checks in. First down stamps at their 53. And to the right side it goes, the hitch to Durant. Back inside. And LeVar Durant got loose. Ball comes out, but he was down at the Ottawa 40. Well, they're going to mark it at the 48-yard line. Well, Rick Campbell brings his team to Commonwealth Stadium, the hub of the Eskimo Empire, and where the dynasty was constructed by his father. And now he's trying to do the same thing in Ottawa.
CFL royalty to the left, folks. And Hugh Campbell, coach of the year in 79, his son in 15. How cool is that? Rick Campbell has built this team from the foundation.
Grant on the end around. He's got something. Lamar Durant down around the 26-yard line.
Dunnigan's comment at halftime was an interesting one, in that Canadians are used to playing in conditions like this where the field might not be perfect. It may be a little slippery. Hey, you know what? No big deal for Canadians. They understand. They know how to run in this kind of stuff. He slips initially and then regains, gets his legs underneath him, gets the edge, and a 22-yard gain for Lamar Durant. SFU product.
53 yards from scrimmage for Durant, and now Mitchell stands in, throws to the corner, nobody there, and maybe he's not on the same page as Matthews again.
No, he wasn't, and it looked like just threw that one out of bounds. Matthews shaking his head, coming back to try and get on the same page, although he was pretty well covered. In fact, two Ottawa defenders had fallen off on 81, so that would have been a risky throw to get it in there.
Mentioned the Calgary injuries, and Matthews in for the last four games of the season. Northorpe's team has given up yardage this year, seventh in the passing category, but only third in points allowed. Looking for a stop here on second and 10. And they scream back to Durant, and Michael Klassen was waiting on it and brings a quick stop to that play. There's the former Stamp, who admitted this week he was not happy to be left out of the Calgary lineup a year ago.
Well, originally a fourth-round draft pick by Montreal. He's right over the center. You come Bray Williams and really just sniffs this one out. I mean, he understands the play, so rather than continue up the field to get to Bo Levi Mitchell, he reads it, smart heads up, good football IQ, underneath, makes a nice tackle on Grant.
Well, the field goal team comes back out, and Rene Paredes puts it up and restores a two-score advantage for the Stampeders. Teams have traded field goals here. as tempers flare. There's defensive coordinator Devon Claybrooks, who got a real scare earlier this season. With more on that here, Sarah.
He sure did, Chris. In late August, he unknowingly found himself in a life and death situation. A neighbor came and found him unconscious in his home, and Claybrooks was rushed to the hospital. When he got there, it was discovered that he's diabetic. His sugar level was at 98. It is supposed to be regularly between 4 and 8. Remarkably, though, after spending 10 days in the hospital, 9 days in the ICU, he has come out of it okay. There are no ill effects long-term for him. He says that he's doing really well right now. He's down to 2 shots a day, and he looks at Rick Campbell as being an influence on his style as of coaching, and he said maybe today the student will beat the teacher.
There's Harris, and he threw that one up for grabs. A flag comes down. Part of the story, his mom talks to him every day, couldn't reach him, and got a hold of the neighbor who found Devon and may have saved his life.
Illegal contact. Calgary number 28, 10-yard penalty. The result will be a first down.
Second flag on Brandon Smith in this Grey Cup game.
Devon Claybrooks will be a head coach in this league in the right situation. His resume, he has worked with Tony Dungy, John Gruden, Bill Parcells, Dennis Green in the NFL, Mark Trestman, John Huffnagel, and now Dave Dickinson here in the CFL.
Wow, that's a list. William Powell gets leveled by Alex Singleton, leading tackler in the league this year, one of the strengths of that Claybrooks defense.
He's a no-nonsense guy, as you know, Chris. I asked him, I said, you know, what do you do if you see on tape a guy with lack of effort? He looked right down at me, he goes, I don't coach effort, I replace it. If that's an issue, you're gone.
And that's a lie, doesn't it? Second and 4, short drop, quick hitter, the slant is caught. Deontay Spencer's got a first down in Stampeder territory.
That's a big one. That's a big one. The sense of urgency as the time disappears here in the third quarter on Trevor Harris is turned up a notch. Down 10, got to come away with points.
Step out at the Calgary bench, and he reaches the 49, so a pickup of 5 yards for Harris. Trevor Harris trying to come out of the shadows of Ricky Ray and Zach Kolaros and Henry Burris. And this year he did that, over 5,000 yards, fourth in the league in passing. Got the two quarterbacks separated by 8 yards passing. Competing in this game, Harris and Bowley by Mitchell. And that one batted in the air and it hung up for a while. Jagarrett Davis gets a hand on the football.
Trevor Harris, when that went off the hand of Jagarrett Davis, he scrambled to try and get there and lost his footing. I mean, he thought this was going to be, it tipped up so high, he thought it was going to be intercepted, so he hustled to it, went down.
Harris caught one that he had batted down earlier this year, returned it for a touchdown. So now on third down, punt team comes in. Do they have anything on here? Does Leone look for the pin? Angles the punt, bounces down towards the 10-yard line, and Williams bounced out there. No yards, a 5-yard penalty will be assessed, and Calgary will have the ball at the 15. 86 seconds remaining in the third quarter. Bully by Mitchell, and the Stampeders lead by 10. The tone of the evening.
Long live the night.
I think that was the theme of the whole week, wasn't it? So the Stamps, with the lead, start deep in their own territory. And Bob Jackson straight ahead has five. A reminder, Molson Canadian Leafs hockey continues tomorrow. Bruins face off against the Leafs in an Atlantic Division game. Coverage begins at 6:30 Eastern on TSN 4 in the Leaf region. And how about Patrick Laine last night with five goals? Christopher Haley of Winnipeg won the Safeway and Sobeys $1 million grand prize as well.
Nice.
Is $100,000 and $1,000 in gift certificates. Pretty good night for Laine and Christopher Haley. Second down, and it's Preskus in the catch. See what they give him for forward progress. Should be enough for the first down. Good year for Jawan Preskus, and it started with the opening game since we did it back in June. And we mentioned he might have the catch of the year, and I think it ended up as the number one catch.
Real happy to have Bakari Grant on the team, especially in this big game. He said he's been a mentor to Breskison, like a big brother. Boy, he had a stretch of over 200 yards, almost 300 yards in a couple of games in September. Big, big target.
Final play, third quarter. Terry Williams in the backfield. Terry Williams, the ball carrier, straight ahead. And a big hole and a first down run. Antoine Pruneau with the tackle. With Williams with the big play in the game so far. And a first down run to wrap up the third quarter. Team straight field goals in the third quarter of play. And it remains a 10-point Calgary lead. Headed to the fourth in the 106th Grey Cup game. The lead remains 10 points as we head to the fourth quarter. We'll check the numbers through 45 minutes.
Well, the last four games, Grey Cup championships have gone down to one possession deep into the game. Nine of the last 11 have. This is not one possession going into the fourth quarter, but close enough. And Calgary knows too well that one or two plays can turn the game.
Everybody knows the theme, and the theme for Calgary has been this year they have to finish.
Have to finish, because when you look at the last 2 years, they have been so close. And I asked Bo Levi Mitchell about this week. And if he changed his preparation for this Grey Cup because of how the last two finished. And he said, I will not change what I've done my whole career over a couple of plays. And that was the difference in the last two championships. Can they finish in this fourth quarter?
So Andrew Buckley in 2016 stopped. He, Bo Levi Mitchell, said, I want the ball in my hands. He had it last year and threw a last-minute interception that clinched it for Toronto. First down and a handoff inside. Doesn't go very far. Tyrese Bear on the scene defensively. And he has his fourth tackle of the game.
Steps up to create a passing situation, slides to the blocking schemes, and then steps up in the hole on Don Jackson.
Can you imagine at that position the way he plays 18 years as a pro? 38 years of age, a testament to his physical training and his desire. Second read over the middle, it's a short hop, incomplete. Intended for Preskison.
And he is rallying his teammates. Kyrie Bear saw that one bounce off the turf and was over there cheering on the offense, cheering on the kick return team, high five in the defense. He knows the importance, and as that time ticks away down 10, how important it is to get the stops.
Get the ball back as soon
exactly.
as they can.
Even a couple of first downs can cost you at the end of the game.
Spencer, the lone man back. Avers punt settles at the 26. 45-yard punt. And now Spencer trying to get outside. Outside of Whit McManus, but brought down and fumble. And McManus is on it. The leading special team tackler has a key fumble recovery as Deontay Spencer coughs it up.
In these games, you never know what player, what special teams guy that does so much of the heavy lifting is going to make a difference.
And in this case, it's Riley Jones, the second-year man out of UBC, who helps create the fumble.
Gets Deontay Spencer around the waist, and you're right, Chris, he gets the ball out of there, and McManus just hustles to it.
Jones, the NBA Cup winner in 2015 with the T-Birds.
One of the leaders in special teams tackles for this Calgary Stampeder team. Went to McManus. First down to cause the initial problems for Spencer. Jones gets it out of there.
A mistake that Ottawa could ill afford to make, and now the Stampeders in scoring position. First down at the 25, they give it to 25. And Jackson fights his way for three. So a huge second down play coming up. Ottawa trying to limit the damage to just a field goal.
You've heard coaches say it many, many times that games come down to four or five plays that make the difference. This is one of them right now.
Often see Calgary go right to the attack on sudden change. They didn't in that case.
Manageable second down for Bo Levi Mitchell, though.
Three-man front for the Redblacks. Fourth man coming, Avery Williams. It's into the corner of the end zone. Too far for Chris Matthews with Corey Tindall in coverage. And so the Redblacks defense does the job.
Chris Matthews going to run the corner route. I thought he had the shorter throw in Eric Rogers. There's Matthews. They're working in tandem to that side of the field. Come off the line of scrimmage. And I thought Bo Levi Mitchell had Eric Rogers for the first down. He elected to try and push it. You know he loves the deep ball. Going after it. Pedal to the metal. And just misses Chris Matthews.
Goes Paredes through, perfect in Grey Cup competition, and it's a 13-point lead. Three more points off an Ottawa turnover. Redblacks have trailed since 4:14 of the opening quarter. Go time now for Trevor Harris with more. Here's Matthew.
Guys have already discussed how Trevor Harris changed his game and Jamie Elizondo kind of simplified it for him. How about his attitude? Well, after week five and that loss to Calgary, Jamie Elizondo went up to Trevor Harris and said, "You're too sensitive. You worry too much about what other people think." Harris actually took himself off Twitter in the preseason, but Elizondo showed him tape of his gestures and how he was reacting to his teammates almost apologetically. They told him, hold them accountable. And Trevor Harris said to me earlier this week, "If I have to be the bad guy, then so be it." And his play has improved. Guys.
Talk to Trevor about his body language after the end of last season. Going to work here. Looking for Erickson. Almost intercepted. Trey Roberson. Unable to squeeze that.
This is a situation where body language is important. And you can see how Trevor Harris has evolved and changed it. Okay, that one was almost interception. Roberson had a shot at it, dropped it. He's not going to duck his head. They said to us this week, they're not a palms-up team, and he's not a palms-up guy, meaning I'm not going to point at receivers and blame them.
Second and 10, here comes Heath. Harris will protect it. And Sinopoli's got it in midfield. Clutch catch and a huge red black first down.
Boy, and he wants to get that first win against the Calgary Stampeders. I mean, he has not beat Calgary, but has been so close. Four games in the last 2 years. His mate right here is Brad Sinopoli. 22-yard gain over the middle.
Third catch for the top Canadian in the 2016 game. Now to the sideline for Spencer, trying to make amends for that. Return fumble and another Ottawa first down as they march back into Lewis Ward territory, but thinking about more than that.
Tempo offense now for Jamie Elizondo. Calling the plays at the line of scrimmage to keep Calgary off balance, get back in it.
Used 10 receivers last week. He's deployed 7 so far in the game, and William Powell isn't going very far toward Darrell Waugh. the tackle.
Trevor Harris is 0-6-2 against Calgary in his career. Two ties in the last 2 years, a 26 all game, a 31 all game. Thrown for almost 1,500 yards, 10 touchdowns, and only three picks, but has not been able to find a way to beat the Calgary Stampeders. Can he do it tonight in the fourth quarter?
Both teams with 305 net yards prior to this play. Harris steps up underneath RJ Harris. Uncovered there and down around the 15-yard line. They left 84 open, and he makes them pay. And he's been shaken up, has to take a knee here. And will require some attention.
Taking a knee will allow the Calgary defense to settle in again because Harris has got him off balance with this tempo offense. I love the decision here, him stepping up in the pocket and not trying to force it into coverage and go for it all. He dumps it down to RJ Harris. He does the rest, takes a pretty big hit at the end of this play.
Harris, the top receiver for Ottawa in the game, Emmanuel Davis. The close that has shaken Harris up, and he was able to hold on to maintain possession. But he's out for three plays, and the sixth play of this drive upcoming. Fiola Godino and Bouillieu in motion. Short drop into the end zone. Stretching out. He's got it. What a catch. Greg Ellingson, touchdown. Well, it will have to be reviewed. Did he make the catch?
Spectacular. The replay system is looking at it now. All scores or potential scores are looked at. Did he maintain possession when he hit the turf?
No, he did not.
Boy, he sold it, though.
And they're lining up for the convert, but of course, the command center has to confirm all touchdowns, and we're getting the word.
The previous play is under review by the command center.
Had he made that catch, that was in the Tony Champion.
Oh, yeah.
Some of the great catches in Grey Cup history. It would have been in that category.
Take another look from a different angle here from the backside. Got the one hand on it. You see the tip of that football hit the turf. You've got to survive contact with the ground once you dive like that for the ball.
After review by the command center, the ball hit the ground and was an incomplete pass. It'll be second down.
Well, we come used to Greg Ellingson making those kind of circus catches. But this one doesn't stick on the board.
Again, body language for Trevor Harris. He's got to flush that one, come right back in on a second and long, an important play right here.
First, second and 10. Open man. It's got there on the sideline, but Sinopoli trying to battle for extra yardage. Thurman able to stop him a yard short to the first down. So what do you do?
Decision time here for Rick Campbell.
Brad Sinopoli, number one in yards after catch this year. Third and a yard and a half, isn't it?
Yeah, yard and a half.
This is a team that went for two-point converts from the three almost all year, and they're going to go third and two here. And in a championship game, I think I'm with them.
Play to win, not play not to lose.
Although you need two scores. Do you take an easy one or not? They're going for the 2 yards, and they've got it. Or no. Do they? That might be a fumble, but they're ruling incomplete. It's Calgary football. Any way you slice it. And they do come away empty. Look Look like Ellingson might have a touchdown. Look like Sinopoli might have a first down. But it's broken up by Jamar Wall. Rick Campbell during the break, late in the timeout for commercial, trying to throw a challenge, but you only get 30 seconds too late. This is what he was trying to challenge.
Well, Jamar Wall is going to play man on Sinopoli coming out of the backfield. He makes a play, but you could see the jam by Emmanuel Davis deeper than that. He wanted a challenge, but he waited too long. You've got to make the challenge immediately before the commercial goes on, and the commercial break didn't get the challenge flag out in time. And they won't review it.
And so Calgary takes over on downs at their own six. And they hand it off to Don Jackson, looking for a critical first down. Jackson short yardage. Well, we've got a whole team of great veterans who have worked this game proudly for the 11 years on TSN. Dave McCluskey's been doing this for 42 years, and hence a special jersey presentation to Dave, who is retiring after this game is done. Dave, we salute you for just a terrific career of work, providing all the great pictures.
Solid on camera for three. His entire career, basically. Boy, we have a tremendous crew and a tremendous team led by John Hines, our producer, and Andy Boyukas, our director.
And hats off to everybody for another great week. Here's Mitchell dashing around. He may take off and plunges ahead, but he'll be short of the first down by at least 2 yards.
Ball lead by Mitchell.
And so Ottawa's going to get the ball back in good field position. Bo's trying to sell the spot, but he is, I think, too far away for Dave Dickinson to even consider it.
Yeah, no shot. I mean, you've got to kick it away. Put your defense, your top right defense on the field if you're Dave Dickinson here. And Noel Thorpe's group got the stop they absolutely had to have.
Sure. If Bo lost where he was on the field there because he thought he'd made it. Spencer field this on a hop. Rick McManus can't get him. And Spencer dropped at the 53-yard line, so they'll start on the Calgary side of half. Eric Metzalira, the rookie out of McMaster, a special team tackle. This cup is walked into the building at this point in the fourth quarter. There's an extra surge of adrenaline on both sidelines. Trevor Harris to work. And looking downfield, that's incomplete. As he tried to connect with Fioli Godino, broken up by Ciante Evans.
Yeah, really, as a player right now, with over 6 minutes to go, you don't even want to see it come in the building because you start thinking about the end of the game before it's over. And as we've talked about, and Calgary fans know firsthand, that Calgary still has 6 minutes to finish here against a very potent offense.
Just thinking, despite this field position and despite being down by two scores, might not be too soon for... Well, they're going to go deep first, and it's knocked down. I'm going to ask you, do you go three-down football now, intended for Ellingson, or do you punt and pin and try and reboot?
Yeah, I think you can go back a couple of decisions and taking the field goal instead of going for it on third down when you were third and almost 2 yards. That was one decision that will be discussed, I'm sure, no matter the outcome here. And again, a couple deep balls here from Trevor Harris, pushing the ball to try and get it all back in a couple of throws where he still has lots of time to run the offense, especially in Canadian football.
Boy, Emmanuel Davis comes close to the interception. Adam Berger, the guy they call the Senator, the veteran safety, has been shaken up.
But to answer your question, Chris, I think you got to kick it deep here. Put your defense, get the 2-1 out, and keep that field position edge.
Next possession.
Exactly. That's your three down possession. Rick Campbell reminding the punt team, be ready the moment that Adam Berger leaves the field. Great Simon Fraser University.
I gotta say, they've churned out some safeties, haven't they?
So Richie Leone trying to pin them once again. Line drives it, and with the bounce over the head, and that's out of the wall. That is a perfect punt by Richie Leone. Exactly what Ottawa needed. 51 into the corner.
Terry Williams looked a little unsure as to whether or not he wanted to play it. The ball bounces up over his head. Out at the one.
So that's the first order of business if you're an Ottawa Redblack fan. Now, the team trailing needs a quick stop. Last two starts for Calgary on their seven. And now on their one. The longest of fields for Bo Levi Mitchell. And goes to the air for Chris Matthews. And that's a big catch by Matthews.
Yeah, is it ever?
Came back to the football, steps out at the 11. That should be enough, though. Well, they're going to be just short.
Between two players that have had some communication issues in this one tonight, but not on this one. This is a timing out where Matthews just got out of his break, rounded off that cut a little bit, but he got there on the short side. Bo Levi Mitchell put four receivers to the field and left Matthews in the one-on-one. Got good production on first down, right to the marker, and gives him some room to maneuver back there.
Nick Arbuckle, the short yardage crew on him. That's a valuable first down for Calgary.
Number nine, Dave Arbuckle, keeping the ball for himself as quarterback.
Now Dave Dickinson goes against Noel Thorpe in the play calling. This point in games with the lead. Conventional wisdom says run the football, pound it up in there, especially on first down. And can you run it when everyone knows you can run it? Noel Thorpe's got to get that front seven up at the line of scrimmage, try and shut it down up front, get him in second and long.
Working the clock. Here comes pressure. Mitchell quickly out of his hands. It's Eric Rogers, and another huge first down, and suddenly Calgary's out of the hole.
Exactly. Two throws from the MOP in the Canadian Football League. On the money. The first one to Chris Matthews on the sideline timing wrong.
Timeout, Ottawa.
Little pick play to Eric Rogers. They've got at least room to punt the ball and no running of the football for Dave Dickinson.
Rogers 6-for-61 last week, 6-for-64 here, and Noel Thorpe knows he can't surrender another first down. Taking one timeout, the 3-minute warning will stop the clock again.
Here we go, guys.
The instructions from Thorpe, too, is to strip the ball if it's a running play, try and tackle the football and get it out of there. If it's a throw and you're a defensive back, you take a chance. Try and jump it.
Terry Williams in the backfield. Long lay offset to lead the blocking. And Williams ahead. And it looks like he surged for five into the 30.
Well, you got to admire the aggressive approach from Dave Dickinson to throw it to get out of that hole from his own one-yard line. Bo Levi Mitchell would have had to have been standing in his own end zone on that first throw. That's a former MOP, former MVP of the Grey Cup game, his coach Dave Dickinson. Got him out of the hole.
Trying to win his first as a head coach.
President and general manager has built a championship team year in and year out. Can they finish?
I think he's anxious to get to the sideline. Second and five. That pass tipped. And almost intercepted. It was up for grabs.
snaps, and the Red Blacks had a shot at it, but they do force the punt team on, and it was Kai Bear who nearly came up with what could have been a game-changing pick.
Not surprised, is it? The veteran in A. Bear, it's tipped at the line. He has a shot at it, but he cuts off Rogers from getting there, because even with the tip, it looked like Rogers had a beat on that football. And without the second effort here from 34, that's a completion and maybe another set of downs.
That D-line had 15 knockdowns during the regular season. They call them shot blocks. Neighbors punt. Spencer, 42-yard line.
Yes, it is. Timed it up. Was outside the 5-yard halo. If you're watching down south, on punts, you have to give 5 yards to the returner. And here's the great ISO shot of one of the best cover men in the Canadian Football League, backup linebacker. Wynton McManus with a monster hit, and Mark Killam, the special teams coordinator, loves it as much as everybody else. Watching that one.
That one's going to be on the special team film for a long time. Trevor Harris on the screen, and William Powell taken down by Alex Singleton. Ja'Gara Davis there. We've hit the 3-minute warning here. It's a 13-point Calgary lead. Ottawa's got the football, and it's still not done. Down the stretch we come in the 106th Grey Cup game. Let's get the temperature on the sidelines first. Matthew Shinetti.
Before the Red Blacks went up, before the third quarter, CC Trevor Harris was trying to get his teammates pumped up. But I can tell you, since midway through the third quarter, the Red Blacks sidelines has been quiet. Now over to Calgary, Sarah.
Tick, tick, tick is what one player said as they try to get through this final 2 minutes and 39 seconds. But they're not celebrating, certainly, yet. One player saying that this feels too familiar. They have to make sure they finish.
It's not inconceivable based on what we've seen the past couple of years. But a lot's got to go right for Ottawa in the next 2:39. Second and 6. Four-man rush. Harris steps up and launches for R.J. Harris. Jabbar intercepted. Brought down by Jamar Wall. And that might do it.
And two monster plays from the 7-year veteran, 30-year-old Jamar Wall. Remember the 2-point convert and the hit on Brad Sinopoli. Took points off the board, or excuse me, the touchdown attempt on third down took points off the board, and Jamar Wall with another big one, an interception. Trevor Harris tries to push it to R.J. Harris. Get a big chunk. And Jamar Wall high points the football.
Two-time All-CFL DB moved to a different position this year at the Sam linebacker spot. And he's had a huge game, and now they'll try and grind it out. Don Jackson inside. Second interception tossed by Harris. Two for Mitchell, two for Harris.
Timeout, Ottawa.
John Huffnagel on the sidelines was in the 84 game here at Commonwealth, part of the winning team with the Winnipeg Blue Bombers.
His reaction of Trevor Harris after the pick. This Calgary defense, though, ranked number one against the run, number one in points allowed. They led the league in giveaway takeaway.
Yep, number one in taking the football away. Jamar Wall had a great line last week about no matter what receiving core we're going to face, I can sleep easy at night, he said. He'll sleep well tonight, or maybe won't get any sleep. There's Don Jackson. And he dropped by Pruneau. And Calgary's going to have to punt it away. So
wanted to stay
there's
in
still
bounds.
Time.
Wanted to stay in bounds, though, Chris.
Yep. Get the clock running.
Get the clock running again here once they place it.
Ottawa's going to get the ball back with just under 2 minutes to go, which we know in this league still is enough time, but their margin for error now is closing down.
And this is where the leaders step up. You heard Alex Singleton. We've got to go. It's not done yet.
Now the game this year, there were three touchdowns treated in the final 3 minutes. Here's Spencer, sidesteps the first wave, but here Luke Garal will bring him down. Time now for the Shaw connection of the game. Shaw, super fan and proud sponsor of the CFL.
Well, after a couple of early drops and maybe some pregame jitters, Lamar Durant comes up with a big one, a touchdown to give Calgary the lead in the football game early on. Well, Levi Mitchell makes that connection to SFU product Lamar Durant.
REDBLACKS start at their own 54. Harris over the middle, and he's got Greg Ellingson. And out of bounds to stop the clock, Adam Berger back on the field as the safety of that Calgary defense.
Now the secondary for Calgary has got to stay off the ball. They've got to be about 15 yards deep, make sure everything's in front of them.
Smith tried to suggest maybe Calgary lost a touch, but a dangerous play by Ellingson, but I think it stops the clock.
You have to be last to touch it. It doesn't count if you're the guy who hits it out of the hand of the receiver. You have to touch it again if you're Calgary to gain possession there. It's not touched before it goes out, so Ottawa maintains possession.
Risky business to try and get the clock stopped, but it worked that time. They've just adjusted the scoreboard here that's been reading 27-20. And you saw some panicked Calgary Stampeders on the sidelines eyeing that. Cushion's a little better, but maybe, oh, there's a pick, another one. And this one is by Trey Roberson. And that one's for his grandfather. And that one's going to do it.
Some ways fitting that it's here. Such a great career here with the Edmonton Eskimos. Trevor Harris has to push it. He needed a whole bunch of big plays to get back in this one. But Roberson falls underneath it. Secures the catch and another turnover.
Only three incompletions last week. Three interceptions in the game. And the general manager of the Stampeders and boss knows it's Calgary's football game. Don Jackson blasting the tackle. We've been talking about the late Larry Hybop, and the grandson has done him proudly tonight, hasn't he?
Oh, and you can see the similarities in Trey Roberson. Three interceptions on the season. In the regular season, none bigger than that in the Grey Cup Championship.
If you haven't seen the feature, check it out on tsn.ca. Five tackles, couple of knockdowns, and an interception for a guy that a lot of people in Calgary believe was should have been the Rookie of the Year this season. Hand off inside is not going anywhere, so here in the final minute, Calgary's going to get it back, or Ottawa's going to get it back. Well, the 3 years of frustration about to come to the end for the team that's really been the class of the Canadian Football League for almost a decade.
Well, every year is a different journey. And in 2008, John Huffnagel, the GM, came back from the United States, from the NFL championship season in 2008. And then not only built a championship team year in and year out, a first place team year in and year out, but had a succession plan in place. Dave Dickinson started as running backs coach, quarterbacks coach, went to OC, offensive coordinator / assistant head coach, and then was ready to take the reins when Huffnagel was ready to step up.
Well, they run it right down and call timeout. And they can finally start to breathe a little easy. Heavy favorites the previous 2 years and couldn't get it done.
All kinds of speculation on the future of Bo Levi Mitchell and whether or not he may take a shot at the National Football League in the offseason. But this team was led by their defense from start to finish this season. And it came through again tonight.
Neighbor's going to work the clock and step out of bounds, so it makes it 27-16.
When I say that, that's taking nothing away from the season that Bo Levi Mitchell had. I mean, at 5,000 yards, when you've lost your entire starting receiving core and had to basically start from scratch with a new group, even though they had experience like Chris Matthews and Eric Rogers, you got to get back to the drawing board with a new group, and they continued to find a way. You know, the last 2 years, Chris, as you know, they'd wrapped up first place with 2 or 3 weeks to go. This year, they didn't secure first until the last game of the regular season. Different types of adversity this year that they went through, and it toughened them up. They found a way to finish.
. 25 ticks of the clock away. Calgary will have to kick off. And Dave Dickinson can smile in the last minute of a Grey Cup game for the first time in 3.
Devon Claybrooks, as I mentioned, future head coach in the league. Jamie Elizondo possibly as well.
You know, think about this, and I know it's a theme you love. This game won as much on the teams as on offense and defense. 3 phases, and the Terry Williams punt return and some great cover, a fumble recovery on punt cover for Calgary. And I think Dave is about to get dunked. Well, they're going to flip it into the hands of Spencer. And he'll get stood up just across the 40-yard line, 16 seconds left.
Well, this Ottawa franchise has so much to be proud of. You think about this team built from the ground up.
3 cups in 5 years. And we might have to get used to them being back over and over again with Rick Campbell. Dave Dickinson's going to coach it up right to the final.
Oh, yeah. Based on the last 2 years, you bet he's going to that final whistle.
And Harris going to load it up. Far side of the field. It's got there by Fiola Godino. He's been trying to get out of bounds, and he gets taken down with 6 seconds to go. So time for one more play.
But you're right, Chris. Winton McManus is not going to have his name on the marquee very often. There's the Gatorade dump for Coach Dickinson. It's an amazing win-loss record in the regular season at 41-11-2.
Final play. Harris, they're not going to get it off. Sacked by Turner, and that is it. The Stampeders are over the hump.
Let's go!
12 of those Stampeders celebrating on the field had lost the last two, and they have time to celebrate tonight.
And they don't have to hear it anymore. Can you finish?
Sarah Leskie's with Bo Levi Mitchell.
Bo, every journey has a different story for it. Your second Grey Cup, with everything that you guys have been through, what will you relish most about this win?
Just being with my teammates. I've got the best team in the world, the best organization in the world. This is a true team after tonight. Defense won a championship tonight. I feel amazing, man. I love these teams. I love this fan. I love our city. Calgary, we're bringing that cup back home, baby.
Said defense was such a storyline, but all three phases contributing. Was this the ultimate team win?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, all three phases. So many times Deontay Spencer could have got around that edge and scored a touchdown. And there's one guy there to make a tackle, and that's what wins you a great cup. His guys having that great cup effort every single play till the clock hits zero.
We saw a couple of interceptions at the end there. What goes through your mind as the time is winding down?
Oh, man, it just all starts setting in. Just all the work, the failure that we've learned from, and to get back on top just feels absolutely amazing.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much. Great cup, Jim!
To Matthew Schinetti with Alex Singleton.
Well, sir, I'm with Alex Singleton, and maybe the bigger sports fan in the Singleton family, his sister, Ashley. Now, first, Alex, you and I were talking this week about one more step, but more importantly, your sister just came up to you. What did you say to her?
We did it. We're Grey Cup champs. No one can say anything anymore. We're the best in the league. We did it.
We talked about one step away. What does this journey mean after the last two losses?
We're Grey Cup champions. I don't care about the past. We did it this year. 2018 is ours for the rest of eternity.
Ashley, how proud are you of your brother?
I'm so proud of my brother. He did great out there.
Congratulations, guys.
Thank you.
Well, that's awesome. Ashley's as big a CFL fan as there is. Alex told us that she not only watches all the Calgary games, she watches every game. And it's a special night for the Singleton family.
Alex with eight tackles on Grey Cup Sunday.
Just another night at the office, huh? Let's go back to Sarah.
I'm joined by Jamar. Well, your first interception of the season, it comes in the Grey Cup. How did that one feel?
Words can't explain it, man. It's a true blessing. It was something I was asking God to give me. And at the right time, man, it came. And I'm just so thankful.
I heard you on the sideline late in that fourth quarter say, we have to finish this game. And then you went out and got the interception. What did this group learn from the last two losses?
Exactly what I'm saying, how to finish. You know, we were in this situation last year. I had deja vu. And that's when it came to me. Make sure everyone knows that we have to finish this game. And that's what we did. And it starts with each individual person. And I did my part and as well as everyone else, man. And it's amazing. It's a great team victory.
For so many years with the Stampeders, we think of the offense, but this defense really led the way and became synonymous with this team this season. What can you say about the group that you guys had?
We all bought in. You know, we always talk at the beginning of the year, if you buy in, we're going to be a great defense, and that's what we did. We had our ups and our downs, but at the right time, we peaked, and we got this great cup victory.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
To Matthew Schinetti with Chris Matthews.
Chris, I think the world saw the disappointment you went through a few years ago. You're now a champion. You're standing next to your father, Daryl. What does this mean?
It means everything, man. We done worked real hard. He done taught me everything, how to be a man, how to step up, how to go through adversity even when times is hard. And I know I showed it on the sideline, but listen, man, my teammates had me. I believed in them. They believed in me, man. We got the win.
How much did we not appreciate what this Stampeder team had to go through with all the injuries on offense?
Man, they were resilient, man. We come out here, we talk about it all the time, man. They talk about how who's going to be up, who's going to be down, who's hurt. Man, we didn't care about none of that, man. We just knew whoever stepped on this field was going to give 110%. And that's exactly what we did, man. You see that score over there, 27 to
16. Can't nobody stop us.
Darryl, your son came back from that disappointment in the Super Bowl. Now he's a Grey Cup champion. How proud are you of him?
I'm so proud. I don't know what to say, what to do. Just congratulations, sir.
I love you too.
And now over to Sarah Lescue with Micah Johnson.
Micah, does this feel sweeter even than 2014?
Man, it's an indescribable feeling, honestly. We went through so much, man. We sacrificed so much. It's just, it's unbelievable, dog. And Mylon, we ain't forgot you, Mylon.
What did this team learn from everything that you guys have been through? You guys talked about the doubters that you guys had with everything for the last 2 years. What did this defense learn?
I mean, just stuck together. We went through adversity. Always sticking together, man. We can count on each other, man. It's pure love in the room, man, in the locker room. We ride and die for each other on and off the field, man. We brothers.
And this defense making plays until the very end, that final play. You got a couple interceptions late in the game as well. Or what were you thinking as time was winding down and you knew you were going to be a Grey Cup champion again?
It was just a surreal feeling, like, just the clock couldn't count down fast enough. We were just ready to see it get to zero and really see the score sitting like that, man. It's honestly just indescribable feeling.
I know you're going to be ready to celebrate. We'll let you go. Thanks so much for the time. Congratulations.
All right.
To Matt with Bakari Grant.
Bakari, you and I have been on a long road together. I've seen the disappointment. I've seen 3 Grey Cup losses. Did you ever doubt that you could have a moment like this?
Never. I mean, you can never doubt it. In this game, anything can happen, and all you can do is, just like the game, it's the next play, the next season, the next time you get, the next chance you get. I mean, I came in, 5-6 weeks ago? I'm playing in the Grey Cup. We won the Grey Cup.
What was that message that Dave Dickinson gave you? How much faith did you feel from your teammates that a veteran like you could be in this moment?
Man, I love it. All I can say is, you know, Dave watched me work since the day I came in, and all he said was, the third day of practice, you earn the opportunity to play in the Grey Cup. And I just love that I got the opportunity and got to help this team win one.
Everything you've achieved in the CFL, where does your mind go to when you're holding your children?
It's my son, man. He's my junior. He's my everything. My daughter, my everything. Man, it goes straight to just being able to have resilience, being able to keep pushing. You know, like they say, I got released at the beginning of the season. I'm a Grey Cup champ now. They can never take it away.
You're a champion, Bakari. CC, Suits.
Yeah, Bakari's brother, a former Eskimo, and yeah. Ottawa Renegade. And Bakari Grant finally gets that elusive Grey Cup ring. You heard a reference to Mylon Hicks, who was shot and killed, a member of the Stampeders in 2016. The player that they dedicated the 2016 game to and came up short. So,
you know, during Grey Cup week, Chris, I ask all the players that I get a chance to talk to, you know, who are you dedicating the game to? And most of them for Calgary this year, with the adversity they faced with injuries, said the guys that fell this year, the injured players, top to bottom. Bo Levi Mitchell said it's for Romar Morris, it's for Kamar Jordan, DeVaris Daniels, Markeith Ambles, Reggie Bagleton. The guys that went down during the year that weren't able to play in this game, he said, we're dedicating this one to those guys, our teammates.
And he did mention that he had been receiving texts this week from players no longer with the Stamps that had been on either last year's team or the year before. And they were urging Bo Levi Mitchell in this edition to finally put it over the top and end the years of frustration. All right, we're almost ready for the award ceremony. Let's turn it over to our great colleague, Rod Black.
Ladies and gentlemen, Calgary, you're about to get your cup. Welcome to the 2018 Grey Cup Awards and Trophy Presentation. To present the awards for Most Outstanding Canadian and Most Outstanding Player in the 106th Grey Cup, the president of Shaw Communications, Brad Shaw, and your host, James Duthie.
Thank you, Rod. First of all, to the city of Edmonton and everybody here today, thank you for being wonderful hosts for the 106th Grey Cup game. The MVP of the 2018 Grey Cup, Calgary quarterback Bo Levi Mitchell. I know every championship is sweet, but after what you went through the last 2 years, how much sweeter is this one?
And this is amazing. It's the most amazing feeling I've ever had, especially with all the failure we learned from it. But I gotta say, the reason it's so sweet is I have the greatest teammates in the world. Defense, they could not wait to tear y'all down when y'all had a bad game. Y'all came back and won this championship. I love my entire team, man. I love Calgary. Thank you.
You're a gunslinger. You have it tattooed on your arm, but with the conditions on the field today, you couldn't be a gunslinger. Tell me about the adjustments you had to make to win this game.
Oh, I mean, the coaches and everybody did an amazing job putting together a great game plan. Guys bought in. You know, we understood the conditions. It was going to be an equalizer. Guys made great plays, man. We went out there and won a game.
Congratulations, Bo.
Thank you so much. Go, Stamps, go!
Bo Levi Mitchell's second Grey Cup ring, his second Grey Cup MVP. The top Canadian in the 2018 Grey Cup, Calgary receiver Lamar Durant. Growing up in Coquitlam, B.C., did you let yourself dream of being a Grey Cup champion and the top Canadian in the Grey Cup?
That's something you always dream of, but it happens to very few people. So for me to do this, man, it just means the world for me. And I love you fans for supporting us and my teammates. I couldn't have done it without all y'all.
Congratulations.
Thanks a lot.
The captains and the coach making their way to the stage. Congratulations.
Hey, you all have won one.
Let's bring in the commissioner, Randy Ambrosi. First of all, Randy, the Grey Cup is not just a game, it's an entire week, and I think I saw you at every party this week. What can you say about this Grey Cup, the festivities, and the game?
Well, I'd start by saying a big thank you to the city of Edmonton for the hospitality. I think this could potentially go on to be recorded as the biggest Grey Cup in CFL history, and they have definitely set a new high watermark for Grey Cups. So thanks to all of Edmonton for putting on a great week. And as far as the game, these are two great teams, and this is certainly a deserving champion.
Present the Grey Cup.
Thank you. Well, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the CFL Board of Governors, the entire Canadian Football League, it's my honor to present J'ai l'honneur de présenter la Coupe Grey, the Calgary Stampeders.
Give me a minute. with the coach, Dave Dickinson. You've won as a quarterback. You've won as a coordinator. Your first win as a head coach. What does it mean to you and your team?
It's big. I mean, I'm very emotional. I got the family here. You know, we played a great team, and we fought hard, but sometimes you're not sure it's worth it all the time. You get some slack in there, but this team was amazing. The group's so tight. Listen to them. I mean, the guys love each other, and that's when you're family, that's when you're at your best.
You've been through so much the last couple of years. I know you tried to downplay that and say that that was erased, and this was a new season, a new team, but it has to be even sweeter.
Well, I mean, trust me, when you do something as a group, it's the best thing in the world. I mean, I wanted this bad. I don't know if I ever wanted a game any worse. But it's more about the players. And what we did as coaches, we just put them in position, and then these guys balled out, and we're going to have fun with it. But we respect Ottawa. They did a great job. We're bringing it home to Calgary. Can't wait to get back.
Congratulations, Coach.
All right, thank you.
I asked Dave Dickinson earlier this week what would be the difference in this football game. He said turnovers. His team got six, and they're Grey Cup champions.
Mantra this week was ABC. Some Edmonton fans said anybody but Calgary. As it turned out, ABC was Alberta Bound Cup. The Calgary Stampeders are the champs. We will continue with more post-game coverage, including some reaction from the REDBLACKS as well. But it's Bo and Alex and the Stamps who celebrate tonight.
One year ago, the Calgary Stampeders watched the Toronto Argonauts do this. 2 years ago, they watched the Ottawa REDBLACKS do this. It's the Stampeders' turn, finally, three straight trips, and they do have the victory. Third time for charm indeed, as they win the Grey Cup 27-16 over the REDBLACKS here at Commonwealth Stadium. Bo Levi Mitchell, the MVP, just like 2014, the most valuable player of a Grey Cup game. And instead of talking about this slide and inability to win big games, we're talking about the Stamps now have won two in the last 5 years. Welcome back to Field Level. Rod Smith along with the panel. Milt Stegall, Matt Dunnigan, Henry Burris. And we thought, what the heck, we'll bring in Jock Climie again, too.
That was nice of you.
Final time. We will get your opinions on this game as the Stamps take it. You know, the pain of losing, Rick Campbell had found it before in 2015. And after a victory 2 years ago, has that feeling again. Here he is now with Matthew Schnetti.
Rick, obviously turnovers are always so back-breaking. Why wasn't this team able to get any momentum in the game?
Yeah, you know, we were fighting and we could have made a game of it there in the fourth quarter, and we just couldn't quite get over the hump. And that's a big thing with us. It's almost of any football team, but with us especially, our turnovers and penalties, and we needed to make sure we take care of the football.
And I imagine too, at the most inopportune times, it just appeared the team was gaining momentum and then there would be a turnover.
Yeah, we finally got some traction, I thought, in the second half, and it looked like it was going to be a close game. And like I said, I give the other team credit. They made the plays that needed to be made, and we didn't.
Thank you, Rick.
Okay, thanks.
You guys have told me many times, I mean, the joy of winning still can't erase the pain of losing a big championship game. And Rick Campbell has been on both sides, as mentioned before. So, you know, the talk about Bo Levi Mitchell, whether he wanted to call it redemption or not, the talk of Calgary's defense, special teams, turnovers, always seem to be a big part of a championship game, and it certainly wasn't this one.
Big momentum change going into that halftime. You know, Ottawa just scored, and they were punting back to Calgary. The half was about to be over.
Terry Williams, big punt return for a touchdown. That was a backbreaker. Deontay Spencer on the punt return, trying to make a play for his team. Totally understandable. Ball knocks off of his knee. Calgary gets a 3 points off of that. That's 10-point swing right there off of turnovers and special teams. And not saying that's the reason why they lost the game.
But it was an 11-point game.
Those were big. Those were big. If not for those plays, they're down by 3 points.
I just look at it. Bo said it. He keeps complimenting his teammates. Says the greatest group of guys he's been around. You hear that all the time. But I think with this group of guys and the resiliency that they showed this year, stumbling down this stretch and regaining the momentum, winning at home in the West Final, I think it really carried over this football team. They played with a lot of confidence, and they got a lot of help deep, deep in their lineup. I'm talking about guys from a bunch of different positions. Canadians stepping up, the defensive secondary. What Joshua Bell has meant to this defensive secondary as a defensive backfield coach, I think is amazing. And watching them go out there and perform and once again frustrate Trevor Harris, I think was critical for this football team. Look, the big boys up front, they could not get pressure on Trevor Harris like they typically could because they didn't have the footing. Those guys in the back end playing it and baiting Trevor to throw balls where he thought he had open receivers, then they shut the door. That was consistent basis. Milt, I agree, special teams was big. Bo Levi Mitchell played things fairly close to his vest, and it was just a survival of the fittest out there, and who was better able to handle the conditions, and Calgary came out on top.
The thing that jumped out at me when I look at this football game is that there was no dominant performances, no 100-yard rushers, no 100-yard receivers, no 300-yard passers. There was one sack each. I mean, no one dominated on the D-line because they couldn't get off on the ball. So when you're in a game like that, it's going to be the big mistakes. That's what's going to dictate the outcome, and that's exactly what happened. Six turnovers. And I know that when Rick Campbell and his Red Blacks go home and they're looking at the film, they'll say, hey, we played a pretty good game. We played a very good team, a very tough defense that did things to us that no other defense in this league is able to do. And we hung in there, and we had a chance. But at the end of the day, when it was down to the wire, they turned the ball over. Hey, Trevor Harris can score a touchdown there with 3.5 minutes left. Yeah. We are in a barn burner.
Yeah.
Turns the ball over, game over.
You know what? Success is a result of hard work. It's a result of learning from your failures, loyalty, and most of all, persistence. And that's what the Calgary Stampeders have been the past 3 years. They lost two Grey Cups. They continue to bounce back. This season, so many players fallen, so many injuries on this team, they continue to fight back. They come out here, they're faced with one of the worst situations I've ever seen in field conditions. They continue to fight back. You got to tip your hat off to this team, this entire organization, from John Helfnagel down, from Ken King, the owner. I mean, you got to tip your hat off to them because regardless of what they were faced with, they always fought back. They always stayed on board. They never swayed from their course. They stayed the course. They continue to stick together. And that's the reason why when Bo did say that this right here, this team this year, meant more. You could just tell how tight these guys were. There was just something different about them. Hey, it definitely proved off for them in the end.
And I think we'd be remiss if we didn't mention the impact this field had on this game.
Yeah.
Players, and hopefully I'm not wrong for saying this, the players, they couldn't do their thing, but I think the fans were cheated also because they didn't get to see the best of these players in this biggest game of the season because of this field.
Okay, I think I'd also be remiss one final time to say 17 years, my friend, it's been great. You've been great, and I'm sure for that reason too. Hey, Stampeders fans won't forget this Grey Cup. For a different reason, I'm sure you won't too.
Yeah, you know what? It's been an honor to be with you guys, and I'm looking forward to spending more time with my kids, and that's why I made this decision.
Yeah.
But
smart.
I will never forget the times that we have all had. This is the greatest sport on the planet. This is the greatest league on the planet.
Wow.
And to be able to cover this for 17 years and play for 12,
that's awesome.
What an honor.
Jocko Mediate, that's what I call him, folks, Jocko Mediate. I want to tell you that Jamie Riddell, I'm going to put it on record, Jamie Riddell, our producer, said that we should do something with you at your house as a segment next year in the Kirk Fritz show somehow.
We got the live cameras in the house.
Well, you know, lawyers are going to charge about an hour so they can get expensive.
There you go.
We'll charge you at the door.
Yeah, we're saying it's over, but it's never really over, is it? But this Grey Cup is over, and it belongs to the Calgary Stampeders. Bo Levi Mitchell, the victorious quarterback, didn't want to lose three in a row, of course, haunted by last year and the year before. Does he look haunted now? A happy man, as are his teammates in red and white. Back with more after this.
Well, how about this for an only in the CFL moment? The Calgary Stampeders champagne celebration in the Edmonton Eskimos dressing room.
The rivals down Highway 2, and they're celebrating right in there, and good on them, because I can't tell you and emphasize enough, Chris, how tough
tough it must have been for the last 2 years for this football team, the core group of this football team, to have to answer those questions over and over, to be so close to the summit of the mountain, but a play or two away from two back-to-back championships, and to keep having to answer that question. Well, they did it tonight. Bo Levi Mitchell now is 2-2 in Grey Cup championships.
And Bo becomes the fifth quarterback to win the Grey Cup MVP and the league MOP in the same year. He joins Russ Jackson, Danny McManus, Travis Lule, and a guy by the name of Flutie, who did it three times and once as a member of the Stampeders.
And the guys touched on it, that this was the ultimate team win in the ultimate team sport.
Come here.
I don't even drink.
Best coach in the world.
The
best coach
shot
in the world, man.
That's an awesome shot with a former MOP, former champion as a player, now gets his first Grey Cup. Head coach Dave Dickinson was 0-2 coming in as the head coach of this football team, now has his first championship as their head coach. But it was the team win. It was Winton McManus and the cover teams. It was the big return by Terry Williams that made a difference.
Got to mention George Hopkins, because he's been with this team for 47 years as the equipment guy. He's in charge of Champagne. Somebody better help him with that cork.
Hold on, big bud.
Pop that cork. You deserve it. I think a guy around 47 years would be more experienced at it. He's got a few cup rings. Come on, George, you can do it.
It's coming. He's working on it.
Here.
Good for him.
A couple special teams guys in there. I'll give you a little hand there. Jeez, that one's stubborn.
It's coming.
It was as tough as winning after two Grey Cup losses.
This team led by their defense, six turnovers in this game. The guys mentioned it. And there we go. Okay, George, nice job. Well, there's no better feeling. Dave Dickinson mentioned on the podium with James Duthie, when you do it together, it is that much more special. And for this Calgary team to have done it after back-to-back losses, man, I just can't imagine how great it feels for the core group.
But a reward for continuing excellence, the team that's won at least 13 of 18 games in each of the last 6 years.
You know, and people said going into this game that they were tired of seeing Calgary in the championship game. They were tired of seeing Calgary finish first. I say no way to that. I mean, this game is about improving every day, putting the time in, the hard work in, and trying to find how to become and get to that level of excellence and maintain it. And that's what the Calgary Stampeders have done year in and year out. So don't move excellence.
Can I take you back to 89? And how sweet is it being in that room after all the work's been done?
Yeah, you almost get emotional watching it. You know the feeling. It's all the hard work that's put in. It's the fighting through the adversity. Every one of those players played hurt at one time or another throughout the season. Eric Rogers had a bad knee all year. He was important in this game tonight. So many guys went down, and you have self-doubt throughout the season, wondering if it's possible, wondering if you're going to get back, if you're Calgary in this case. And then to finally get there and finally hit that summit and put that flag with the horse in it right at the peak.
And Peter fans hanging around, and some great shots from a champagne-soaked dressing room here at Commonwealth Stadium. Back with the final word from the 106th Grey Cup after this. Dave Dickinson hoists the Grey Cup, and the Calgary Stampeders are the champions of 2018. You know, Suits, when we get a chance to talk to the players, there is a common theme about overcoming adversity, but I'm not sure Calgary's ever faced more and gone on to win a Grey Cup title.
Well, you know, whether it's in football or in life, adversity has a way of hardening you. It has a way of making you, forcing you to cut out all that doesn't matter and sharpen your focus on what does. And this was a different journey for Calgary. Calgary went through so many injuries, especially in their receiving core. were so resilient and no longer have to answer that question, can you finish? They finished this one. Congratulations to the organization, to John Hoffnagel, all the way on down. They earned it.
Mentioned 12 guys celebrating tonight had lost the last two. Nine, I believe, are celebrating for the very first time, and nobody celebrating in Ottawa, except if you can step back and
exactly.
assess what they've done in the last 5 years.
Well, 5 years, three first place finishes in the East Division, three Grey Cup appearances. They won one 2 years ago in 16. They battled hard here in this game tonight, and they just came up against a team that was destined to win this football game and end that discussion, and that question is whether or not Calgary could finish. But, you know, good job by the Ottawa Redblacks. Their season, they've built for success, sustained success. Marcel Desjardins, Rick Campbell, tremendous integrity in that organization, all the way through to Trevor Harris and that football team.
So we've completed an 87-game journey. It's always interesting. Can you reflect not only back but ahead now to what should be a very eventful next month? And we say hello to the fans in Halifax. Looking forward to progress on that department after being named the Athletic Scooters officially on Friday night.
Well, you know, first of all, hats off to the Edmonton Eskimos, the Edmonton organization, the city of Edmonton, for taking the festival up a notch. Outstanding performance all week long by the city of Edmonton. The commissioner has some challenges in front of him this offseason. He's got to work with the CFL Players Association and get a new CBA, a new collective bargaining agreement put together, and try and do that before free agency, where a lot of top-name quarterbacks will be on the market. And he will continue to work to make this game safer for the players. But, boy, we're in good hands with Randy Ambrosi, and the future is bright when you consider, as you mentioned, Chris, that on the horizon is the Atlantic Schooners football team to make this a true 10-team league from coast to coast. And he said it in his press conference. It's a matter of when, not if. I can't wait to see what happens in the future.
I want to echo our congratulations and thanks to the city of Edmonton. It always knows how to put on a show, even if it is for the visitors from the south celebrating on their turf here tonight. We want to thank our crew. And Suits, we want to also say a special shout out to Jock Climie. Our crew's going to be down one Queens guy, so we're going to be a little weaker next year.
Good job, Jack. Great job and great career.
Thanks for everybody for watching a game this year, and for Calgary Stampeder fans, a night to celebrate that was well-earned and long-awaited. And for those Stamp fans, long live the night, and so long from Edmonton.
Red's got fading. Let's do this right. What you drinking's what I'm drinking. Who's got a light? We about to kick off this 9 to 5 from dusk till dawn. Man, it's on. CFL on TSN. Music's playing, yeah, we're swaying. Crank it to 10. These stars are falling like confetti. So wish on one for the gone. Third and one from the gun underneath those Thursday night lights.